And hi again, everyone. Al Michaels at the Continental Airlines Arena in East Rutherford, New Jersey, for Game 5 of the 2000 Stanley Cup Finals. Very few things in sports are as exciting as a team clinching the Stanley Cup, especially doing it at home. That could happen tonight with a New Jersey win. But keep in mind, amazingly enough, over the last 12 seasons in the Stanley Cup Finals, the home team is 26-33. It doesn't figure, but here we go. It should be a wild night in New Jersey. Game 5 coming right at you. It's hard enough to win the Stanley Cup, and even tougher to repeat. The season is long, and the journey is filled with injury and pain. Dallas won the Western Conference title, but through four games of the Stanley Cup Finals, Brett Hull, Mike Modano, and the Stars have run into a quicker, more passionate opponent. The New Jersey Devils survived a stress-filled regular season. Coach Robbie Fedoruk was fired on the eve of the playoffs, and Larry Robinson took command. Robinson's name is etched on the Stanley Cup seven times, and the team has responded to the change as he's pushed nearly every right button. Now Claude Lemieux stands on the brink of his fourth title, and Jason Arnott his first, as the New Jersey Devils, up 3-1, can close out the series at home. The Dallas Stars must find a way to win, or the engraver goes to work tomorrow. Tonight, Game 5. Davidson and JD, I talked about the road team having so much success in this series. The road team has won 3 of the 4 games. How in the world do you explain that?
Well, Dallas is a road team, Alan. They're down 3-1. They're on the ropes. But to me, they're loose, and they look like, as champs, they're ready for a war here. I think they're going to come out and have a very good first period. With New Jersey, their coaching staff have treated this almost like a road game. They want them to be focused, not worrying about where they're going to go to after the game if they happen to win this thing. They've been in hotels the last 2 nights just to try to stay focused for what should be a very good game.
New Jersey has to win just 1 out of 3. Dallas would have to win all 3 to be the Stanley Cup champions. As usual, the focus on the goalies. And for the Dallas Stars, Ed Belfour has had an off and on series. On the other side, Martin Brodeur, a prime candidate for playoff MVP.
Pads for legs, $1,500. Glove for hand, $400. Mask for face, $150. Having a slinky for a spine, priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. Official card of the NHL and fan of those who dominate the game.
2000 is awarded. For that to happen, the New Jersey Devils must win. They lead in this series 3-1. An exceptional road record. Now can they come home and win game number 16? Are they nervous? Well, Bill and I were just smiling at one incident with Peter Sikora.
I can tell you the team that is less nervous than the other one is the Dallas Stars. Larry Robinson's guys now have something to lose. They are expected to win, and the nerves are relative to the expectations. The Devils now are supposed to win the Stanley Cup. The Dallas Stars are down 3-1. The expectations are lower. They are not as nervous and did not look as nervous this morning as the Devils did.
Peter Sikora, in his pregame skate about a minute ago, went through center ice and dropped his stick inadvertently.
Nobody around him at all.
Don Koharski, the referee, had to pick it up and hand it back to him. Dan Mariwelli, Don Koharski are our referees tonight. Ray Scampanello and Jay Scherz will be the linesmen. They're removing some excess water from the ice. Netminders, they've met before. Eddie Belfour.
And there's no reason to think that Ed Belfour will not have to be well, superhuman in this hockey game to force a game six. This is going to have to be his best game in the playoffs.
We are underway. Into the corner. Mike Modano's line is out there. Zuboff, Gary Lettinen, Mike Modano knocked down. Brett Hull was in front of the net, but Rafalski got there first. Cleared out the center. Jamie Langenbrunner not playing in tonight's game. He will be out. That'll be the only change in either lineup for tonight's game. And looking for his 50th career playoff win that would get him a cup, Martin Brodeur.
And Marty Brodeur's demeanor really helps him in situations such as this. He is an easygoing, laid-back guy. Yes, he's got butterflies going, but he doesn't seem to be an overreactor. In general, though, the team that has the sleep advantage, the Dallas Stars, I'm sure they slept like babies last night. A lot of the young guys that play for the Devils have been saying, I haven't slept in 3 or 4 days. Forget about just last night.
Four great rookies for the Devils who've had outstanding regular and postseason games who have helped them to this point where they could put it away. Hancher cleared it up. Morrow knocked it away. Cravenel intercepted by Madden. Madden dumps it in. Madden became just the second rookie in NHL history to have a game-winning short-handed goal, as he did it in that last game in his second short-handed chance. Knocked away, Matt Tkachuk back in behind the net. McKay was on him. Dumped near side, Morrow coming up to get it. Brendan Morrow has been held off the board here in the last 10 games for Dallas. And the Devils coming up with great forechecking pressure. Nemchinov had it, lost it to Guy Carbonneau. Carbonneau cleared it around for Keane. Danico stepping up. Danico pinched in. Hey, held it in.
No retreat. None at all. The Devils look like they're going for it here. I mean, you can't back up this early in a game. But you also know how big the first goal of the game will be for Dallas's emotional state, one way or the other.
Absolutely. Pandolfo shot off the glove of Belfour. Intercepted Lemieux right through the middle. Came wide. Shot back in Colin White. White, one of those rookies, 22 years old, has played exceptionally well in the playoffs. So good that he is a plus 10, the best plus minus, along with Patrick Elias for the New Jersey Devils, and the best in this playoff year. One for a rookie, the other, Patrick Elias. Unbelievable. Third backup, looking. Malikov dumped it. They'll come through center. Bobby Holik to the corner for it. Belfour forced out the play. Belfour trying to clear it out. Pandolfo held it in. Off for Bobby Holik. Intercepted. They'll run it out the center. Never got it out of the zone. On Lemieux down low. Belfour! There's the first big save of the game. Eddie Belfour and Jay Pandolfo. The first great scoring chance goes to the Devils. Claude Lemieux back out. The Devils starting out with a flurry. Into the zone off Manson. Belfour played it near side. Cote's got it. Cote got it up the wall to Mike Modano. Modano moving it up. Mike Modano dumps it in. A whistle on the offside call.
Well, if there was any concern about the New Jersey Devils playing not to lose, that has been dispelled. Larry Robinson's guys have come out here with as much fire as they have in any game so far in the series. Jonathan Sim, interesting play here. He had broken his stick. He tried to hand pass it out of the zone, and it ended up leading to the first really good scoring opportunity for the Devils. It was Claude Lemieux's backhand, and Jay Pandolfo tried a little redirect. There's John Sim when he came out. I'll tell you what, the Dallas Stars have come out here to do business, but they've got a lot of energy. Mike Modano was skating. John Sim is. Everybody looks like they're ready to play. That could change if the Devils score first.
Niedermeyer takes it in behind the net. Modano right in front of him. Intercepted. Dumped it back in. Taken back by Scott Stevens. Cleared up Ilyash. It'll go into the New Jersey bench. First period. Game five. Cup could be awarded here tonight. Brian Englund.
The New Jersey Devils have 31 points from rookies in these playoffs. That's an enormous number. Two of them had great games in game four. John Madden is a 27-year-old who grew up on the wrong side of the tracks in Toronto, and he's a scrappy kid. He uses that knowledge on the ice. Brian Rafalski is a 26-year-old who spent the last 4 years playing in Europe. He has great hands, but these two guys have just been unbelievable clients for the New Jersey Devils. Where will they go from here? A guy like Brian Rafalski doesn't even know, he's not even known by anybody else. New Jersey Devils seem to turn these guys up everywhere. Gary, Bill?
Larry Robinson says, I don't view them as rookies.
How can you at this stage? I mean, they've come through everything from recovering from a 3-1 deficit in the series in the conference finals against the Flyers, and were key people in that series. It's no wonder Larry Robinson doesn't look out and see rookies when he sees them.
And we've commented all along, Bill, watching these games, how it doesn't matter what point, what score, where we are, what game, Larry Robinson will put those kids out there at any point, any time, in any situation. Jason Arnott is one of those who has had a magnificent offensive playoff year. things were expected when Jason Arnott was Edmonton's first-round pick in 93. He made an immediate splash, scoring in his first NHL game, en route to a 33-goal rookie year. He also showed he would not back down, not to anyone, including those he would confront again later in his career. It may be that Arnott will be standing tall when the 2000 Stanley Cup Finals are through. Martin Brodeur picks it up. Jason Arnott has picked up 7 goals, 12 assists in this playoff year. He has been a great member of that number one line.
But what a great influence the captain of this team had on Jason Arnott. When Arnott came to the Devils, he was a confused athlete, a confused person. So he moved in with Scott Stevens and his wife Donna and their 3 kids, Caitlin and Ryan and Karen. Many nights, Donna Stevens and Scott Stevens sat up around the kitchen table talking about life, talking about everything from nutrition to fitness. Jason Arnott developed a whole new appreciation for life and a greater confidence. So,
save made Brodeur, and Yuri Lehtinen in front. Matt Tkachuk took the shot. Richard Matt Tkachuk at the point, who's got their best plus minus of +6 in the playoffs, almost got his 3rd goal.
Well, what's really interesting is that the New Jersey Devils have a 3-1 lead in games, but they don't have one guy that's above 50% in faceoffs. That time, Jason Arnott lost it cleanly back to the point. Joe Nieuwendyk won it. Marty Brodeur had to have x-ray vision through a bunch of people to see this. Look at that. It deflected off his own defenseman, off Scott Stevens in front, and came right at him.
Here he comes again. Matt Tkachuk held it in, and Madonna's line getting opportunities pushed by Hatchett. Matt Tkachuk will have to chase that down. Face-off-wise, Madonna's won 53%, Nieuwendyk 60%, Carbo's 61%, and as you said, Bill, the Devils don't have anybody over 50, and amazingly, that has not seemed to matter. In front shot, save Belfour! Oh, the second big chance, Peter Sikora, on a turnover by Dallas, was right in front. Eliash held it in. Sikora, Eliash, and Jason Arnott. This is that amazing line that has scored 23 of the 59 goals in the playoffs for the New Jersey Devils. Dump deeper. Sikora's got it. Looking for Arnott. Cutting goes back. Rafalski wristed it wide. Wide side. Eliash will chase it down. Madonna on him. Eliash got it in front. Save on Sikora again by Belfour. Stevens can't hold it in. Wow. This line just never quits. Pandolfo shot it wide. He was just coming off the bench in a line change. Lemieux held it in. Blocked to center by Yuri Lehtinen. Picked up by Hull. Hull's been the Dallas Stars' only consistent offensive player in this series. Shot that one wide. He's the only 2-goal scorer they've got here in the Stanley Cup Finals, and he leads the team with 3 points in the finals. Backed in front. Nope. Blocked it out to center. No. Stayed in. Lemieux picks it up. Leaves it Halik. Halik with Pandolfo. Pandolfo leaves it. Shot Colin White. Save! And Belfour had trouble with that one as he was leaning one way and the shot came to his right the other way. Nieuwendyk takes it back in behind the net. Joe Nieuwendyk playing at a -3 here in this finals. Intercepted Lemieux in the middle. Pandolfo! He was open and then slipped. Sim knocks the stick out of Colin White's hand. Down low, Manson trying to clear and does.
Boy, now it's the Dallas Stars that look like they're jumpy. Dave Manson on one play stepped up in the neutral zone, missed his man. That led to one scoring opportunity. But the Devils are trying to get this thing done early. What has to happen here for Dallas is, while Eddie Belfour is holding him in, they got to stabilize. Remember, they have to play as smart as New Jersey, not only as hard.
White in behind the net. Each team with 2 shots, no score. 7 minutes into period number 1 of game 5. Right back up, McGillney stripped away at center. They could not control it, and Sidor will come back.
That's a second huge effort by a New Jersey Devil from lying on their face. I mean, Pandolfo had one. That was McGillney flat on his face and still made the play.
And they are offside on the dump in as Kurt Muller had moved ahead of Roman Lyashenko. Delighted to have you with us. ABC's coverage of the Stanley Cup Finals. Will this be the final?
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for coming. And in closing,
welcome back. As we all know, goaltenders are a bit of a different breed. Dallas goaltender Ed Belfour is a very introverted sort. He's not the gregarious kind of guy that goes out of his way to make conversation. But one thing for sure, fellas, he is an extremely superstitious guy. His skates that he's wearing tonight, he has not worn since game 6 when they hoisted the cup in Buffalo. Gary and Bill, they had to fix the toes. They were so worn out.
Well, he hopefully will bring them the luck tonight to get this series back, obviously. Madden in front, deflected it away. Niedermeyer along the near side wall, couldn't get to it. Guy Carbonneau sends it in. Looking out in front is Keane. As Keane, Carbonneau, and Brendan Morrow working on this line. Right up until the escape tonight before the game, Ken Hitchcock wasn't sure who he was going to put out there on that fourth line, making decisions after the skate was made, or at least was unwilling to talk about it. 4-2 the shots.
Well, he's tweaked his fourth line so many times in the playoffs and in this series, but he hasn't gotten any results in this series. So I think that Ken Hitchcock, while he's looking for answers, not sure he spent that much time on the decision because it hasn't made a difference in the series.
Sedor, the defenseman, playing like a forward, ran it all the way in and followed the puck, but could not get to it. Back to the point, Sedor, nice hold. Sedor will dump into the corner, got knocked down and moved up by Rafalski. Jason Arnott with it, Eliash on the left side. Eliash checked away, Zubov. Fine defensive play by Sergei Zubov. He joins the offensive flow as well, Madonna to Hull. Hull trying to move around his man. Hull looking back to the point, Sedor. Shot off the stick that time. Fireside Zubov. Zubov's got Sedor cutting in. Zubov a blast, deflected wide. Sedor's shot deflected off the side of the net. Rebounded to center, Sikora. Zubov's back with him. Sikora moving. Sikora got in front, lost control of the puck, and Belfour will hang on. Dropped it off to Madonna.
Zubov really hard to beat one-on-one. And Sergei Zubov looks like he's come with a gun loaded, ready to shoot. Yep. And a different matchup. He's being matched up against that Arnott line.
That's what they've got to do, as we've talked about Zubov's unwillingness to shoot always here in this game. You're right. He's cocked that cannon a couple of times. Eddie Belfour cleared it around. Thornton along the near side. Held in Malakhov. Zubov helped him clear. Colin White comes back to get it. 5-2 the shots in favor of the Devils here in the first period. Out in front, Neuendijk was looking for it, but it came to center. The last team to stave off an elimination game when they would have been out of the playoffs, back against the New York Rangers in 94. Vancouver did it. No one's done it since. Into the middle, Lyashenko will take it back in behind his own net. Roman Lyashenko around the boards. Grant Marshall back in. Marshall out the last three games to Manson. To Lyashenko in front. Backhanded Brodeur. Rebound side of the net. Held on to it. A big pileup.
Oh, that would have been the bonus goal for Dallas right there. The Lyashenko line out there. Grant Marshall knocking on the back door. Trying to bank it in off the back of Brodeur. That would have been the big bonus goal. That would have allowed Mike Modano and Brett Hull to start putting up numbers and try to get to the grand total of three goals in a game against New Jersey. Check this out. The 3-on-2 that was well executed went back into Grant Marshall and he got the first one, but then he tried to backdoor it, bank it in on Brodeur. Nothing doing. So the two goaltenders at each end, Eddie Belfour and Marty Brodeur, seem like they are in the groove right now.
Should this Stanley Cup Final Series continue, we'll have it for you on ABC. If a Game 6 is necessary, it'll be Saturday at 8 o'clock, and it would be back at the home of the Dallas Stars. A Game 7 would be on Monday at 8, right back here in New Jersey. And, of course, the quest for the Cup on ESPN at 7:30. Keane dropped it off. Guy Carbonneau got it. Carbonneau got tied up. Bandit taken away by Gomez, who moved it out. Near side to McGillney. McGillney into the zone. 3-on-2 now. 3-on-3. Niedermeyer a chance. Deflected. Guy Carbonneau came up with it after it had been blocked by Matvichuk. Sergei Breland. Keane got leveled by Danico on the far side. Off the boards, McGillney. Quick passing by the Devils has been a tune of this playoff year. Gomez, the rookie, off the side of the net. Rebounded by Breland to Gomez. Gomez, Breland doing battle over there for the Devils. Couldn't hold it, though. Keane took it away. We'll get it back. Keane intended for Matvichuk in the middle. At the end of a shift, he'll take a chance. Glove down. And Brodeur's got to cover up as he had Hatcher moving in. Hatcher has not had a point here in the Stanley Cup Finals. Was going for a goal there. Bud Light Stanley Cup summary. Looks like this. Brett Hull, 22 points, leading the NHL. The Eliash Arnott-Sikora line. What a playoff year. And the Western Conference representative has won the last four Stanley Cups. Devils trying to end that.
Well, there's the most constant driving force in this franchise's history. Ken Danico. And he is playing like a kid right now. Gosh, he's got so much jump in his legs. I talked to him the other day, and he said, I feel like I'm in my 20s again. I'll tell you what, Mike Keane probably feels like Ken Danico is that young again, too. That is how you take a man. Mike Keane just rubbed off the play.
Kenny Danico, 17 years, all with the New Jersey Devils, and 186 teammates that he has played with in his year in New Jersey. It's a long Christmas list when it comes to December 25.
Well, some of those guys, he probably doesn't remember their names by now. I mean, that's a long time ago, and some weren't here very long.
Played by Stevens in the corner. Stevens up the far side. Devils, those rink-wide passes have broken their offense open here all year long. Sikora trying to move it in, taken out of the play by Sador. Jason Arnott goes back on top for Stevens. Hull intercepted. Brett Hull moves it up. Hull looking for room. Devils line it up. Madonna couldn't get it in. Rafalski. Madonna again reached back for it. Would be offside, but Rafalski clears it out, so no whistle. He feathers that to avoid the icing. Back goes Randy McKay. Got in front of Zuboff. Got taken down. Zuboff tied him up, and Grant Marshall came back to get it. Good work by Marshall on the help. Niedermeyer gets it back. 6-4. The Stars with the advantage in shots now. That'll be whistled on the offside. 9:26 to go. First period. Game 5. A Devils win. We'll see the Stanley Cup. Dodge Different Intermission Report upcoming. Al Michaelson Company, John Davidson included, John and Barry ringside. We'll have the analysis of the first period and a look ahead as well. With 9:20 to go in the first, no score. Stars out shooting the Devils 6-4. Matvichuk back on the touch, and that will be an icing call. Coming up on ABC Sunday, the American team is looking to capture the U.S. Cup for the first time since 95. To do it, they've got to defeat their arch rival and defending champion Mexico from Giant Stadium. USA versus Mexico soccer, Sunday at 1 Eastern, 3 Pacific on ABC.
Scott Gomez was naturally keyed up today, and he said that he had played for the Stanley Cup hundreds of times as a kid, playing road hockey, playing minor hockey. I asked him if he'd ever won. He said, I've won the Stanley Cup so many times, they had to put new rings on it to get my name engraved.
And he had the game-winning goal in every one of them. Hatcher's chance is blocked up deep. Lemieux's got it. Lemieux looking up front. Brought in by Pandolfo. And a penalty coming up. First call is delayed. It's going to go on the Stars. There's the touch. A hooking call. And the Devils will get the power play. And White into one with Thornton, who moved in. And Sim went after him.
Yeah, it's Jonathan Sim that's really trying to stir it up for Dallas, and he's doing a pretty darn good job of it. And most of the time, Sim is locking horns with Colin White. They're hometown buddies from New Glasgow, Nova Scotia. But here it is. Darian Hatcher ends up drawing the first penalty of the tilt, so that'll put the Devils on the power play. Power plays will be huge in this game if anybody can capitalize on them, because the way these guys are going, you can expect it to be a low-scoring game. Brodeur is strong in goal already for New Jersey. Belfour strong for Dallas. So expect it to be a low-scoring tilt.
Hatcher is out of there. Power play chance, hooking call, 11:01. Eddie Belfour will face the first power play of this game. The Devils are 2-for-12 in this series on the power play, 12-for-66 in the playoffs against the penalty killing unit of the Dallas Stars. The best penalty kill in NHL history regular season has got to get it done here. Cleared out by Zuboff on a faceoff win by Dallas. Held up, they go back in behind the net to start it up ice. On the power play, so few goals have been scored by either team in the power play. Jason Arnott has one for the Devil. Bobby Holy, Jason Arnott, Patrick Galiash, Peter Sikora back at a point, and Rafalski on this first power play as Larry Robinson goes with one defenseman, Rafalski, on power play unit number one. Rafalski stepped in to block it. Holy covered for him at the point. Goes to the corner all the way around. Jason Arnott on the far side. Arnott sends it back. Galiash. Bobby Holy will try and set up in front, and a penalty coming. It'll cost New Jersey. Power play time, 1:19 worth of power play time will be lost as Bobby Holik will go on the interference call.
And it was Richard Matvichuk that he was up against along the end wall. And Matvichuk was just about out of gas. He had been out there for a long time trying to get the puck out of his zone. If Bobby Holik doesn't pick up a penalty on this play, he might just wear him out by wearing him down. But it didn't happen. Interference is the call, so Holik evens things up. There it is right there. That's Mavichuk, and Mavichuk was out of gas to a degree. Mavichuk looked like he made that one seem pretty good, and the leak didn't get much wood on him. So if you can get the call, make it go your way. I mean, the Dallas Stars have to pull out all the stops. It'd be really tough for Dan Marowelli or Don Kowarski to call an unsportsmanlike for a dive in a game like this. So you might as well try to draw the penalty.
Yeah, but it worked for Mavichuk that time. So we'll have a 4-on-4. In the playoffs, the Devils have scored one 4-on-4 goal, if none scored against them. Dallas has not scored one, and they've given up 2 4-on-4 goals this playoff year. Lemieux and Sador are doing battle along the near side wall to the right of your screen there as they try and get set for the faceoff. Sador and Lemieux keep creeping in. Modano and Madden on the draw, won by Mike Modano, back to Cote. Hull will be out there with Modano, Sador, and Cote, the two defensemen. John Madden up. Cote had to bang that one out through center. Niedermeyer and Stevens, the defenseman in the 4-on-4 situation. Madden and Lemieux. Claude Lemieux will move it in. Lemieux dropped it off to Madden. Madden wanted to turn back to the middle of the ice, but didn't have any room as he got cut off by Cote. And Dallas will take over. Back up through center. It'll be a short power play, barring any other calls for Dallas coming up. Hull got it in. Niedermeyer was there. Off to Stevens. Stevens turns it. Looking rink wide for Lemieux in the middle and got him. Claude Lemieux over to Niedermeyer. Niedermeyer back to Lemieux. Lemieux. And centering pass. Deflected up in the air by Gomez. What a chance for Scott Gomez as Eddie Belfour was on the ice.
That's why Claude Lemieux is a big game player. He waited and waited and looked like he was going to pull the trigger, and everybody thought he was going to shoot. Instead, he passed and just about banked it in off Gomez.
His 220th playoff game. Sunday Night Baseball coming up. Coverage will begin with Baseball Tonight, brought to you by Pep Boys at 7:30, 8 o'clock. The Mets and the Yankees in interleague play. The Subway, and that's all that separates these two. Mike Hampton, David Cone, the starters Sunday night. Baseball history in this city has a lot to do with the man in the back row right there. He's a great Devils fan, Yogi Berra, the great Hall of Fame catcher and outfielder for the New York Yankees. Yogi's on hand for a lot of games, and Yogi attends a number of games. Great friend of John McMullen, the owner of the New Jersey Devils. Jersey Devils have mentioned it more than once. John McMullen, their owner, sold this team to the corporation that's going to own the Yankees and the Nets. John McMullen will be in the middle of July no longer the owner of this team. And the players feel strongly about John McMullen. You said at the top, it is an added impetus for this club to win another Stanley Cup for him. Power play, opportunity, 36 seconds left on it here for the Dallas Stars. Sador gets it in. Neither team able to do anything in the 4-on-4. Devils penalty killers have not given up a power play goal in their home ice this playoff year. 0-for-21 for the opposition here in New Jersey. That's how strong they've been. Both these penalty killing units are exceptionally good. Gary Lettman, Neuendijk, Stevens knocked it away. Sador stepped up to hold it in. Down to 7 on the advantage. Stevens blocked it away from Neuendijk. Pandolfo giving chase. Madden, the shorthanded man in the middle. Let's that one go. Zubov penalty over. That's Bobby Holik out of the box. So both teams 0-for-1 on short power plays here. Cleared around for Nemchinov. Dallas completes a line change behind the play. That's Cote. Good pass. Got Kurt Muller. Muller a blast. Save made. Straight in. Artem Brodeur saw it all the way. Into the middle, Sikora. Look at this long passing. Eliash overskated Jason Arnold. It tells you how much the Dallas D are backing up. Sikora trying to dump it in. Modano over to get it. Modano cleared it up. Devils finding a lot of ice, Bill, to put the puck through rink wide east and west.
But the Dallas Stars pride themselves on taking away the cross ice passes. So if the Devils are completing them, it means that the Dallas Stars are not positionally perfect.
They're backing up a little bit here, allowing that room at center ice. 8-4 the shots, though, in favor of the Stars. No score first period. Stanley Cup is here at the Continental Arena. Awaited. Maybe. Save made. Brodeur, and he jumped off the ice to get that one, but he got it. And the Devils are making sure nobody gets close to Martin Brodeur.
Great play by Brodeur. When he jumps like that is to make sure he has complete control of the rebound. And Guy Carboneau had a high riser that came at him. He jumped to make sure that he could stun the shot and not lose the rebound.
Martin Brodeur, 9 shots, 9 saves for Brodeur. This is the Continental Arena. And inside that building, in its case, Lord Stanley's Cup. The tenseness of a game where the cup can be awarded just mounts as the minutes tick off. Everything matters. And for Dallas, they're running out of time. For New Jersey, they want it done right here. Fireside, Keen almost taken down. See, the Stars have outshot New Jersey in the last 8 minutes, 7-6. The total 9-4 on the board. Back up with it, McGillney. His chance wide, short side. Held in by Gomez. Gomez, McGillney, and Breland have had some chances on this line here in the first period. In behind the net, Gomez the hit, but Keen will play it on the far side. Had to send it back for Matvichuk. Bouncing puck ran up the stick. He came back to get it, but Breland's got it. Breland a shot. Tip Gomez. Belfour covers and picks it up with a glove. Devils may not have all the shots, but boy, they had some chances for Larry Robinson. Don't forget our Stanley Cup Finals on ABC. If a Game 6 is necessary, 8 o'clock Saturday night Eastern time. A Game 7 would be Monday, 8 Eastern. All games preceded on ESPN with a quest for the Cup. The games right here on ABC. Michael J. Fox, who's played some hockey in his life and is a great fan as well, on hand here in the Meadowlands.
Being a good Canadian, wouldn't have guessed any differently than that. Good pressure by Scott Gomez there on Richard Matvichuk, and that forced the turnover up the boards to Breland with the rebound just about on the stick of Scott Gomez. But Ed Belfour, similar to the other end. I mean, we could be in for a classic goaltender's duel here.
These two are in it. The Jersey Devils in the playoffs this year have given up only 22 shots a game. Stars have 9. That in and of itself is a good sign for them to give them a chance. With New Jersey playing as stingily as they have in the shot department.
If you're looking for positive signs for Dallas, just look at the shot total. The Dallas Stars have equaled their high in any period in this series so far, and they got 4:20 to go in the first period. In 11 of the 12 periods played so far in this series, the Dallas Stars have had 7 shots or fewer in 11 of 12, so 9 ties their high.
Intercepted on the break in, Patrick Eliashuba. Sliding into the net. I do not think there was a penalty called on that. Don Koharski put his arm up to stop play, but I do not believe there's a call.
I don't think there is either, Gary, and I think what happened was when Elias got the shot off, he kind of dove forward to see if there was a rebound there. Mike Modano kicked it back, and he kicked it right to Patrick Eliash, who split the seam. Oh, I'll take that back. Eliash looked like he was falling down before he took the shot. As a matter of fact, watch this. He's actually falling when he shoots, right? There, I mean, his feet were off the ice. The Stars dodged a big bullet on that one with no penalty being given to Zubov.
Patrick Eliash, we said, 7 goals, 12 assists, plus 10. Number one in plus minus in the playoffs, and Colin White is defensive teammate. Knocked on the far side, Manson. Pandolfo couldn't get it. John Sim dies to Thornton. Thornton, Sims on the right with him, and he's offside. Sim can fly, but he was a little too fast on that one. First goals, how much do they matter? Well, for these two teams, the Dallas Stars, 11 wins, 3 losses when scoring first, but 2 losses in this series have been when they've scored first.
So you wonder if that number means anything at all. I do know that the first goal, if Dallas gets it, will give them life. If the New Jersey Devils get it, then there will be perhaps a nail in a hand and a hammer in the other hand, driving a nail into that coffin lid for the Dallas Stars. So in an emotional sense, forget about those past numbers. This game means more emotionally about the first goal than any of those other games.
How about the Devils 6-5 when the opponent scores first? I find that to be an amazing number in the playoffs.
That tells you how they just keep coming. And that is what's most impressive about the Devils. In game 4, trailing 1-0, they come out into the third. They outshoot Dallas 15-4, so they have a killer instinct.
Thornton a chance. Rebound! Bounced over Sim's stick. Boy, there was a break for the Devils. As John Sim was coming hard, and it went over his stick as he tried to rifle a rebound chance. That'll be a two-line pass with 3:24 left to go.
Well, we've talked already about how superstitious some of these guys are. Mike Keane has 3 Stanley Cups tattooed on his ankle. The tattoo parlors will be quiet in his neighborhood if they can't win here. And you see that blazer that Mike Keane is wearing? That's an oldie. He had that in 93 when the Montreal Canadiens won 11 overtime games. That jacket is 11-0 in those overtime wins. He wheeled it out for Game 7 in the conference finals against Colorado. They won that one. That beautiful red jacket, at least Mike Keane thinks it's beautiful. is 12-0 in the playoffs, undefeated.
Mike Keane, who's looking for another cup here tonight to keep that hope alive. Lyashenko got tied up, taken away by Nemchinov. Kirk Muller moved in on him. Madden had it, Lyashenko got it. Madden pickpockets it away, can't keep it. Danico puts the hit. Centering pass, Lyashenko dropped it off. Went to the side of the net, not on net. Grant Marshall with it. Marshall looking out in front. Send to Muller, wraparound chance, block. Niedermeyer blocked it, and the Devils will clear. Out comes Eddie Belfour. Played it off, Marshall. Ooh, dangerous chance right there. Belfour came way out. You see the most of any period in this series. The shots for Dallas, leading at 10-6 in that department, but no goal yet. Cole. Brodeur plays it up and out, changing the D behind the play. Zuboff had just come out on the ice. Back at center, they get onside. Zuboff in, dropped it off. Freeland was there, left it for Jason Arnott, who got it away from Yuri Lehtinen and cleared it in behind the net. Eddie Belfour back. 35-year-old Eddie Belfour has always struggled against the Devils. 4-5-7 in regular season games against them. This is the first time the Devils have matched up against Dallas in Stanley Cup playoffs. Set in, Jason Arnott got tied up, cleared around, Hull on the far side waiting. Hull dropped it, intercepted, Eliash couldn't control. Mike Modano trying to move it in camp. Modano had to back up with it. Mike Modano, gonna be frustrating, blasted at center. Again, the rookies and the youngsters getting it done. Eliash moved in that time to take it. 4-on-3 the other way, Zubac, Modano, and he went behind him. He was wide open, but he couldn't draw it back.
Boy, that is a perfect example of being handcuffed. Mike Modano was in such an awkward position the way the puck came to him, he couldn't control it. What a break that would have been.
No goal, 2 assists in the finals for him so far.
If he's a right-hand shot, he gets this easily. Mike Keane crossing on the right side, dumped it back into the middle to Zuboff. Look at this blind pass. But here's where Mike Modano says, oh, let me be a right shot. A right-hand shot has a one-timer right in the wheelhouse. A left-hand shot has a set of handcuffs on his wrists.
Amazingly, he did not have a goal in last year's finals, but obviously was effective as an assist man. He had 6 assists in the 7 games last year when they beat Buffalo.
And remember what Joe Nieuwendyk was doing last season.
We didn't
really notice Mike Modano not scoring. Why? You never do when somebody else or other people are getting the job done and your team is winning.
And that's what they have not been able to get done this year. That'll be intercepted. Kenny Danico takes it back. It'll be whistled on the delayed offside call. Can Modano get hot? Mike Modano has been the cornerstone of the Stars offense for 11 seasons. The first overall pick in 1988 displayed his brilliance to fans in Minnesota, where his flashy play helped lead the Stars to the 91 finals. He would not return to the finals for 8 years. Injury and constant attention by the Buffalo defense was a price that he had to pay. However, Modano and the Stars prevailed, raising the Stanley Cup for the first time last year. Still, the guys we were talking about last year with Mike Modano, the all-time Stars leader in playoffs. Last year, Nieuwendyk and Langenbrunner had 21 goals and 17 assists in the playoff year. They don't even have half of that this year.
No, the magic was not here. And to complicate matters, Jamie Langenbrunner hurt his knee. He's not in the lineup tonight, so Joe Nieuwendyk toils away with really a couple of checkers on either side of him and hasn't been able to find that offensive chemistry.
Under a minute left to go in the first period. No score, 11-6 the shots in favor of the Stars. There were no tickets available for this game as everyone wanted to be here just in case tonight was the night the Cup's awarded. We talked about John McMullen, the owner. He has been the chairman of the board. He moved the team from Colorado and brought it here. 18 years he's been chairman. They came to New Jersey in 82. He hired Lou Lamoriello, the highly successful GM. John McMullen, one of his favorite people.
Here, you talked about the meeting they had. There's Ken Danikos, who's been here since day one. The meeting was so emotional when John McMullen told his players that he was selling the team. Dr. John McMullen got choked up. Most of the players did. And that's when they resolved to win the Stanley Cup for their beloved owner. They really love this man.
It is amazing how that affects athletes of today, because we spend so much time, and I'm not saying it isn't rightfully so, talking about money. This isn't about money. Hulling! Banned on it! Hulling trying to center, get it out in front, came back to the line. inside. Belfour still doesn't have his stick. Lemieux had it blocked by Yuri Lehtinen. Lemieux doing battle to hold it in. Belfour still without a stick. Goes out to pick it up. Rafalski can't dump it in because they hadn't cleared the zone. Shot it into the bench. A 2-on-1.
Could that have been a killer? Could that have been a killer goal against the Dallas Stars? We were down to under 30 seconds to go when Bobby Hajdúch received the pass. He waited and waited, and I'm not sure if he waited for the puck to settle down or just to make sure this was going to be a perfect shot. Eliáš with a nice little dish. It jumped. Settle. He waited for it to settle. It never did, and then he was running out of time, so he had to try it even when it was rolling. And then Scott Stevens stepped into the slot, couldn't get good wood on it. I'll tell you what, if the New Jersey Devils score there, that would be basic hugey right there with less than a minute to go in the first period of this possible elimination game. You don't want to go into the locker room if you're the Dallas Stars with anything negative, nothing.
Down to 4 seconds left to go, and the Devils will run it off. Stevens winds up, one last long shot. Belfour makes the save. And Bobby Hajdúch wishes he had that one back. Hull may have got a piece of his stick as he tried to take that shot. Belfour and Martin Brodeur have shut him down. 11 shots for the Stars and 7 for the New Jersey Devils. The cup is here. The Devils trying to take it. And Claude Lemieux one more time to be on that cup. Dodge Different intermission report coming up. Al Michaels and company after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Welcome back, everybody. We go to the second period, scoreless. Brett Hull leading in goals scored and points in the playoffs and hitting officials.
Let's skate! Sorry, Holly. I seen your stick coming. And I'm saying, Brett doesn't know who it is.
I was just hoping they're gonna roll off one way or the other instead of just standing.
I didn't know if anybody was behind me.
Well, fortunately, that didn't really impact the play. The Devils got the puck out of the zone. Brett Hull back checked. You hear what he said there? So I thought, I was hoping you were going to roll off me instead of just standing there. Don Barsky had the right answer. He said, I didn't know if anybody was behind me. So, you know, he couldn't make any sudden moves backwards. He could have crashed backwards into somebody.
Yep. First 5 games of this series have been tied at the end of the first time that's ever happened in the Stanley Cup Finals. You want to look ahead. New Jersey's outscored Dallas 10-4. In the second and third periods combined. We are underway in the second period here. Gary Thorne, Bill Clement, and that one is offside. Faceoff at center.
Well, we mentioned that there was at least a positive number for the Dallas Stars in the first period because they outshot the Devils and they hit double digits. But if you look a little deeper and look at scoring chances, the New Jersey Devils had 7 scoring chances to Dallas's 5. A lot of Dallas's shots were long shots. Sometimes shots aren't the only indicator. If a player has a good close scoring chance and shoots wide, we still consider that a scoring chance, whether it's a shot on goal. That is the same area that we had a pane of glass just explode in game 2 of this series.
Trying to get that clamp, obviously, plexiglass clamp down over the ridge, and they do so. That's right in the runway where the teams to where the New Jersey Devils come on and off the ice. In behind the net, just underway here in the second play. And centering pass deflected. Zubov trying to hold it in, can't, and that will be whistled in the offside. What Bill was talking about in that same area.
Mike Keane came up against it, didn't really hit it that hard. All right, it was pretty hard. Jay Pandolfo was squeezed between Mike Keane and the glass. You know, Gary, I never have noticed on that replay whether or not the glass had that divider that they were just inserting. Because that's the door where the players come on and off, and as soon as it's closed, they put one of those steadiers, a little divider to hold it in place at the top, and I never did notice on those replays that had been forgotten for the broken piece.
Next time we look at that, we'll look at the top of the picture instead of the middle of it. And that will be touched up for the icing call. Want to remind you, the Stanley Cup Finals will continue on ABC, if necessary. Game 6, Saturday, 8 o'clock Eastern, the home of the Dallas Stars, Reunion Arena. There's a Game 7, back in the home of the Devils, right here. That would be Monday at 8. Saturday, Monday, 8 Eastern, if necessary, Game 6 and 7. We are delighted to have you with us here on ABC, our exclusive coverage of the Stanley Cup Finals. We're at the Continental Arena in New Jersey. Gary Thorne, Bill Clement, and our crew on hand. Ryan Engblom, Darren Pang, along the ice level. Shot on, deflected in front by Bobby Hajdúch. moved out. A Pandolfo was up ice ahead of it. Taken and onside. Bobby holding a rebound. Just wide. Oh. It went on Matvichuk.
Oh, for all of the times Richard Matvichuk has made heroic saves bailing Eddie Belfour out, what about the irony of that? That almost went in.
That was close. Held in. Lemieux. This line has created some great chances for the doubles. Holik, Pandolfo, and Lemieux. That'll be touched as Dallas just shot at the length of the ice to take the heat off.
Oh, there's Richard Matvichuk saying thank you, thank you, thank you. Because that just missed. The shot from the point missed. The puck was just laying on the blue line, close to being offside, but it wasn't. Good call by the linesman. Here comes the shot that just zipped wide through Bobby Holik's legs, and when he spun around, he just tried to rip it in front. Off the toe of Richard Matvichuk. Watch this. Right off the skate of Matvichuk. Slide. Had it all the way, Eddie.
Yep, no problem.
Don't worry, bud, I had it all the way.
Easy once it's gone by to the corner.
Yeah.
Dallas also fighting against their road record in the playoffs. They've won four but lost five and have been outscored 22-27 on the road. Not like the Dallas Stars, at least of the regular season. Wandering a bit, Martin Brodeur, and he got it out of there. Manson's back. He'd stayed behind Gomez. Niedermeyer on the ice with Ken Danico. Danico looking into the middle to Gomez. Deflected away from him by Manson. Up from Madonna. Hook checked away from him. Deeper into the zone. Danico back to get it. Madonna played 8:15 of the first period. Only Brett Hull played more. Madonna had one shot. The leading faceoff man. Madonna was 7 out of 9 on the draws. Sent back into the corner to Manson. Manson moving it up to Grant Marshall, or tried to. Gomez intercepted. Finally came to Marshall. Breland took it away. Breland does battle. It deflects, just chipped out of the zone. Marshall will send it in. And Danico will have to chase it down. Played back up, trying to catch him in a change. Gomez. Gomez gets it in, and the Devils will change up here. Eddie Belfour tries to do the same thing the other way, trying to catch the Devils coming over the boards. Neither works.
And if you get a chance to get your team into the change mode, this is the period to do it, because it's the long change. You're farther from your bench. It's smart to make those plays, dump the puck in deep when you can sense that your guys are getting tired, to make sure they have time to get to the bench.
Randy McKay for Nemchinov on the near side. Nemchinov came over to get it. Good play. Nemchinov brings it in. He got hooked down. In the corner, still loose. Randy McKay. Nemchinov moved in to help to John Madden. Madden taken out by Hatcher. Up the near side boards and out of the zone. Keane. Keane trying to dump it. Ended up going on net. Pushed away. Morrow out there. Carbono. And Guy Carbono reached in before they had cleared the zone. Tonight's Dodge Different Flashback poses the question, has a team ever made an in-season coaching change and gone on to win the Stanley Cup? Well, embattled Robbie Fedoruk was fired with 8 games left in the regular season. Larry Robinson took over as head coach with a chance now to win the Cup. Should the Devils win, Robinson will join the legendary Dick Irvin Sr., who took over Toronto in 31-32, and Al McNeil, who replaced Claude Ruel in Montreal in the 70-71 campaign. They are the only coaches to take over a club during the year and win a Cup. Saved by Eddie Belfour and Elliott. Here's Jason Arnott. His shot deflected out deep. Elliott trying to run it in. Got it back in the backhand. Yared Lehtinen knocked it away. Sidor to Hull. Hull and Madonna coming. Madonna on the left side. Yeri Lehtinen, Zubov joins it. Zubov got it into Madonna. Madonna wristed in front, deflected away by Eliash.
Oh,
Sidor.
Brett Hull was wide open.
He had it cocked for that one timer. He had wound up. Madonna tried to center. He had a shot and tried to pass it over to Hull. Zubov left it for Sidor. And a rush put on by this line, but not resulting in a chance. Sikora. Save made in the glove of Eddie Belfour.
Boy, you can tell Eddie Belfour's in the zone. I mean, these are rockets that the Devils are firing at him, and he is making them look slow and easy. Here's Patrick Elias with one big windup from a perfect spot to score. Belfour had to come up with a shoulder, but I mean, he has very little movement. Watch this. Here's the Sikora chance just moments ago. Easy one with the glove of Ed Belfour. Doesn't move very much when he's in his zone. And he is absolutely that in that right now. Elias Arnott, Sikora combined for 6 goals, 9 assists in the series. That is the line. that the Dallas Stars have to try to negate.
What a playoff they've had, Bill. 23 goals and 32 assists, 55 points for one line in the playoffs. Knocked down. He had trouble. Collected near side. Martin Brodeur battled that one a little bit on the dump in from center. Thornton in front. Short side. Rebound. Another save. Conte. Martin Brodeur. Or this is a 1-0 game, and Conte would have had the goal. Malakoff back to get it. Over to Nieuwendyk. Nieuwendyk to Thornton. Nieuwendyk. Thornton and Sim on this line. Manson sent it all the way around the near side wall. Thornton. Thornton jammed off the puck. Conte can't hold it in. An icing call coming. Netminders are in battle.
Kind of had a hunch that this could turn out to be a goaltender's duel and a classic at that. Eddie Belfour is making them look easy. Marty Brodeur didn't make this one look easy because it wasn't. A couple of point blankers. The first one by Thornton, the second one by Sylvain Côté. Marty Brodeur went down and he raised the one leg. I'm not sure he had to. I think it hit his bottom pad. But if Côté had been able to get it airborne, maybe, just maybe, the Stars have a 1-0 lead. Brodeur was like a wall in there.
Look at that. Career playoff goals against 1-9-1. He's had 7 shutouts in his playoff career. Into the corner, Hatcher's got it. Taken away by Gomez. Near side, Breland. Breland, Morrow stepped up. DiCarbono back to Morrow. Morrow dropped it, but Gomez had it covered. Gomez around the net. Gomez, the rookie, probable rookie of the year when they're announced in Toronto at the end of the playoff season. Held in at the point. Shot deflected off the blocker. Niedermeyer with a chance. Breland held it in momentarily. Then it shot out over his head. Kane cleared at the length of the ice. The touch will get a whistle on the icing call. Martin Brodeur, already one of the game's all-time outstanding netminders. Martin Brodeur has unique NHL roots off the ice. His father, Denis, the longtime photographer for the Montreal Canadiens. On the ice, Martin has enjoyed longtime success as well, backstopping the club to its only Stanley Cup championship in 95. He also is one of just 2 goalies to actually score a goal in a playoff game, turning the trick in 97 against the same Montreal team his dad has been a part of for so long.
Well, athleticism kind of runs in the family as well. Besides being a photographer, his dad, Denis, backstopped Canada as their goalie in the 56 Olympics in Cortina to a bronze medal.
Not bad. Learned well, father to son. Elias off the boards. Played up by Lettinen. Stevens drives it right back out. Sidor the other way to Hull. Hull trying to turn in, taken out of the play. Hull and Stevens on the far side for a moment. Adano back to Hull. He's open and blocked. Elias. Not only does this line score, it back checks. Hull taken out of the play as he tried to wind up. A reminder, Sunday, the American team looking to capture the U.S. Cup for the first time since 95. They must defeat the arch rival and champion Mexico to do it. Giant Stadium, the site, USA-Mexico soccer, Sunday, 1 Eastern, 3 Pacific on ABC. And of course, Giant Stadium is right across the way from where we are right now. Giant Stadium, where a little soccer is going on tonight. In fact, right next to it, the Meadowlands, the Continental Arena, home of the Devils, where we are tonight.
Well, this Continental Airlines Arena, at 5:30, all of the parking lots immediately surrounding the building were full. I mean, they tried to route me to a remote parking lot.
Marshall Moore, and again, Martin Brodeur. Now Niedermeyer in the corner, could not control, dumped back in behind the net. So Nieuwendyk is out there now with Kurt Muller and Marshall. Bobby Holik lost it. Malakoff knocked down by Muller. Malakoff and Muller do battle. Down they go. Kurt Muller held it in. Looks to the middle. Nobody there. Pays for it as Colin White put the hit on. And the Devils will move it out.
What this is about is getting Joe Nieuwendyk a double shift because he's out there with the guys that have been the fourth line wingers.
Malakoff, Bobby Holik, 2 chances, 2 saves. Eddie Belfour. Bobby Holik on the rebound chance. Graham Marshall's got it at center. Marshall back in after missing the last 3. Centering pass Brodeur, and he'll cover that with Zuboff moving in. 14-12, the shots in favor of the Stars. The Stars win it, and we will go back to Dallas. Second period, Devils, Stars, game 5, no score.
The Stanley Cup, on which Martin Brodeur has his name engraved once because of saves like this. hoping to get his name engraved a second time. The cup is in the building, because the Devils can clinch if they can get by Dallas in this one game, game five. Marty Brodeur would repeat.
Martin Brodeur looking for that big 16th win of the playoff year. Little work being done on the ice here. Martin Brodeur, 58 wins this year. That ties him for second all time in the number of wins in any given season, where you combine the regular season and the playoffs. And if he can get that 59th win, his name will be on the cup again. Sim shot blocked out deep. Looking up ice, Colin White got it into the middle. Pandolfo will chase to the corner. Belfour came out to play it. Pandolfo cut him off near side. Of course, Belfour had to make a good play as he had to go around the far side boards. Intercepted again by White to Pandolfo. Pandolfo off the wall. Neuendijk knocked it down. Neuendijk getting some extra ice time, but that one's going to be whistled on the two-liner. Giving us a chance to check in with Brian Engblom. Right.
Eddie Belfour is the man in the hot seat. He's the guy who has almost no margin for error. And Darren Pang talked about the special skates that he's wearing tonight, the one he wore in game six against Buffalo when they won the cup. And in the first period, everything under control. Eddie has looked like he's controlled his environment extremely well. When he's had to scramble. There are occasions that certainly call for that at the very end of the first period. He certainly had to do that. And he had a little bit of good luck, too, as we saw one grazed by the post off of Matvichuk. Maybe there's still some mojo in those skates.
Eddie Belfour will take all the luck he can get in this game. So far, he hasn't needed any. He has been the Eddie Belfour we expected to see before this series began.
Eddie Belfour had a streak coming in that went to 9-0, winning a game after a loss in the playoffs. Devils took care of that, and now are trying to tag him with a couple L's in a row. Played back by Hull in the middle, and can't get it back to him. Zubov's going to play it. Madonna, Hull, Jerry letting him back out. Madonna forced back deep into his own end. Mike Madonna with Lemieux on him. Back up for Zubov. Zubov got sent in. Bobby Olick blocked it. Stevens back out.
No room in the middle. I mean, you can tell when these teams are on their game and they're starting to clamp this thing down. There's no room in the middle of the ice. Always people there.
Puck was hit with a high stick, and that's the whistle. Stopping play with 12:50 to go in the second period.
Boy, that's kind of a tense look on Ken Hitchcock's face, is it not? I mean, the sense of urgency is upon him. Sergei Zubov here tried this pass in the middle. Look, I mean, you've got Bobby Holik there, then you've got two defensemen right behind him. The team that not only plays the hardest but the smartest will most likely win this game, especially because both goaltenders seem to be on top of their games. The smart play, when there is no room in the middle of the ice, is to get it deep and get your forecheck going, and that was part of Dallas's plan, deep and forecheck.
Jason Arnott, who only won one of five faceoffs in the first period, gets this one and a shot. Well, not really. It was deflected wide of the net by Eddie Belfour off the stick, but it wasn't on net. Back comes Brendan Morrow. Morrow looking to move it in. Niedermeyer just ties him up, taking onto the play. Danico around the near side. Eliash tied up by Cote, who held it in. Now bounces off the near side boards and out. Guy Carboneau will come back to get it. Carboneau in his 230th playoff game, second all time, closing in on Mark Messier. And that'll be tied up by Eddie Belfour on the dump in for the draw. A reminder, SportsCenter coming up 11 o'clock tonight on ESPN. There'll be a post-game analysis and reactions from New Jersey. Steve Levy, Barry Melrose will break down game five and either a look at a cup awarded or a game six to come. SportsCenter.
There's Guy Carboneau. He is still wearing a cast on his right hand. They're removed after every game, but they're permanent casts that were customized to be able to wear when he plays. He avoided surgery by wearing the cast, but guess what? He tore ligaments in one of his fingers against Colorado. He will have to have surgery when the season is over. Just out of curiosity, take a guess, folks, if you're watching this game, since I'm telling the story. Guy Carboneau's 40 years old. He's going to have surgery on his hand. He's wearing a cast on it because he's got a broken bone. Who is leading this series in faceoff winning percentage? That man.
He has been one of the great draw men and defensive forwards in the game's history. And one of the toughest, hard-nosed players. You do not get him off the ice. Just don't. Rafalski came back to get it. Cleared it around the far side boards, and it bounces out to center. Knocked away off McGillney. Guy Carboneau is in his fifth final. So is Mike Keane. So is Claude Lemieux. They are the leaders in final series played in.
You know, of their unsung people in an organization. Here's one right here. I mean, the athletic trainers, the medical trainers on the staff, Dave Supernaut, the Dallas Stars. You have to be an expert at so many things, including the art of making casts that are playable, casts that can be customized, removed. The reason they have four is that the way you get slashed and the wear and tear in a cast, you have to have backups. Dave Supernaut didn't make two, didn't make three, he made four. He kept his guys in the lineup last season all the way to the Stanley Cup, even though seven of them were ending up getting injections by the time it was all over.
Billy was telling us the playoffs are a piece of cake. He went through the most injury-prone season he's ever had as a trainer in these Dallas Stars, like 400 man games.
Second only to Montreal.
Lost during the regular season. You don't think that wears and tears on a trainer?
And relative to the regular season, this team is very, very healthy. You see the Guy Carbonneau who never takes off his right glove. That's where the cast is.
He said, I can take any of this stuff. These are just game-related injuries.
Well, it's a walk in the park. I mean, they have six and seven guys out that need a treatment daily for most of the season. Sometimes they have eight and nine guys on the shelf.
They've got most of their people back, obviously, but Jamie Langenbrunner has been a big loss for him. Cleared back out. Cross ice, Danico up for Freeland. Freeland trying to gun it in. Eddie Belfour had trouble with it. McGillney moved in, partially blocked it. McGillney trying to jam it in. He had no angle. It deflected off the side of the net and touched Eddie Belfour and came straight out. Knocked down Danico. Got help from Gomez, clears it out. Gomez wearing number 23. The man who used to wear that and captain the Devils is here with his son tonight, Bruce Driver. He was the last captain before Scott Stevens. Picked up by Niedermeyer. Niedermeyer up the far side. Lost it to Hull. Hull can't hold it in. McGillney's got it. McGillney off Matt Tkachuk and touched someone over there on the Dallas bench.
Well, Alexander McGillney knows how to rip him to the top corners. We've seen him do that in this series, but he would have taken this one. Watch this, an interesting play. Gomez, a little redirect. Watch where the puck goes here from McGillney. Between the stick and under the arm of Ed Belfour. A little bounce, it catches a little cloth, or it bounces off the stick. Maybe it finds twine, although I'm not sure it had enough steam to get to the twine, but all it had to do was get over the goal line.
Executive producer of our hockey, Larry Christensen, our producer, Tom McNeely, and director, Doug Holmes. We talk about people we never get to recognize. Zuboff dumps that one in wide. Rafalski came back to get it. Claude Lemieux off the boards and out the center. Sidor played it off. Madonna's got it. Madonna trying to run it in one-handed. Got double-teamed. Zuboff did feather it along the near side wall. Cleared right back out by Rafalski. Zuboff waits for his teammates to clear. Hull giving chase. Rafalski knocked him off the puck. Claude Lemieux came back to get it. Put it back in behind the net. Still up in the air. Lemieux moves over and takes it down and not out. Madonna in behind the net. There's Stevens. Boy, if they met often. Virtually every strike. Madonna, even strength shift. Madonna's out on Stevens. Is there. Shot letting and wide. Blocked. That lead by Holik. Centered again to Hull. Hull into the corner. Taken by Stevens. Nemchinov to Lemieux. Claude Lemieux swept away from him. Stevens back in his own end. Dallas pressing now. They'll make the line change. We are halfway through game five. Second period, 10 minutes to go. And no score.
Well, there was a major tweak in the lineup, or at least the way he put his defensemen and his forwards out there for Ken Hitchcock. And I'm liking it right now.
Here's Colin White. White center came into the middle of the find room in the slot for a pass. Nobody can get the puck to get it to him. Sidor looking to clear and does. Boy, there have been some chances. Sim takes another shot from Colin White.
You won't get a better chance than that, that Bobby Holik had. I'm not sure that Eddie Belfour saved it or if he hit the side of the net. And John Sim is still doing what he has done really effectively in this game. Try to get the Devils out of their groove, off of their game. And he's doing it to a kid that he grew up with. That's Colin White. These guys grew up in New Glasgow, Nova Scotia. They're 3 months apart in age. They're the best of friends. Claude Lemieux and Joe Nieuwendijk are not the best of friends. That's why they're doing what they are doing. But Bobby Holik with Pandolfo wide open in front. In the side of the net.
Best-selling light beer, the official sponsor of the NHL. And a beautiful evening here in the greater New York area. Guy Carbonneau won the faceoff back to Cote, scoreless. Shots are now 14-14 in this period. The Devils are out shooting Dallas 7-3 here in the second period. There are the shots after the Stars had the advantage in the first. Danico back will touch that one up, and that is an icing call. Our Dodge Different intermission report coming up. 8:58 of playing time left here in the second period. That's where our guys are set up, right there in the corner over by the Zamboni door. Al Michaels, John Davidson, John and Barry ringside as they keep an eye out on the game, and they'll be with us. Our Dodge Different second intermission.
They got the protective glass down. When they turn and face the cameras, the protective glass comes up lest they get one on the noggin from behind. Face-offs, one thing has been consistent. The Dallas Stars have been the better face-off team. It hasn't meant a lot as far as the outcomes of the games, but even in this one, 28 wins for Dallas, 14 for New Jersey.
Keith Carbono wins another one. And it's out to Matvichuk. Matvichuk cleared it up by Danico and in. Martin Brodeur will cover with Guy Carbono coming in. A little lean there. Make sure he does not run in to Martin Brodeur.
Well, the Devils had a scare in game four. There's their big man that centers Eliash and Sikora on their big line, Jason Arnott. He took a hit from Darian Hatcher. He actually had a bridge of teeth knocked out of his mouth. They found out from their trainer before this game that Jason Arnott had been rocked by Blake Sloan earlier in that game. So it was kind of a cumulative effect by the time Hatcher hit him. That's why they were worried about a concussion. But 20 minutes after the game, Darian Hatcher, 20 minutes after the game, Jason Arnott was showing no signs of the hit.
He leads the Devils in this series with 6 points, and he is tied for the playoff lead as Arnott and Eliash both have 7 goals and 12 assists. Lead New Jersey in those categories. Picked up by Nemchinov, set up ice, great pass shot. Eddie Belfour knocked it away. Nemchinov came in and followed it up. Bobby Holik to the far side, Lemieux centering pass. Belfour's got a cover. That was a centering pass that almost went in off the back of Belfour, off the stick of Bobby Holik.
Go back to Jason Arnott for a second and really show you why the Devils were so worried about his health after game four, because in game one he was a huge factor. He means so much to this team offensively. In game three, he split the big pair on the blue line for Dallas and also scored. Then in game four, this is what happened. He got hit by Darian Hatcher, and watch this. As he went down, we always like to show you false teeth on television, and we don't give you a great view of them. But there they were. Larry Robinson knew they were teeth on the ice. Couldn't get the penalty call, though.
Madden on the faceoff and swept wide by Pandolfo and the chance. Muller to marshal it out. But he said you don't see Bridgeport falling in many sports on whatever the arena floor is. I said there aren't many arenas where players have Bridgeport. Up the near side, Marshall out in front. Marshall gets it, sent into the wide side corner. Kurt Muller, that one batted off the dasher. Marshall in behind the net. Marshall trying to run it out in front. Cote came up to help. Pinching down the D, Manson was the only man back covering up defensively. Cote hustles back to help. Pandolfo in, left it, open, McKay, save! Rebound in front, and it's swept to the side. Madden over to get it. Madden, right center to McKay. McKay trying to get a shot off. Got double teamed on the near side. Cote originally blocked him. And Kurt Muller will send it in. More chances. Played in behind the net. 7:20 left to go. We're in the second period. A Devils win. And we will see the Devils skate the Stanley Cup. A Dallas win. And we go back for game six. Bouncing puck. Belfour knocked it away. Hatcher in the corner. Sergei Breland. Breland tied up. Deflected by Madonna. Back in behind the net. In front is Gomez. Pass to him. He almost got the shot off and hit the side of the net with it. Gomez coming down the middle has had a couple of chances in this game. 3-on-2 the other way. Moving in Sim. 3-on-3. Backhander handled by Brodeur.
You'll take it from wherever you can get it, even from your checking line. With a right winger named Randy McKay, if you can get any offense, come on, baby, give it to me, be there. An end-over-ender that Eddie Belfour didn't follow with his eyes, but he knew it was going to hit the blocker. Then John Madden kind of complicated things for Belfour by being the first there for the rebound. He could never get it off cleanly. Randy McKay's last goal was March 24th against the New York Islanders. That is 28 games ago.
He is one of nine remaining Devils from that 95 Stanley Cup champion team.
Larry Robinson, you can tell as tailored a suit as Larry Robinson is wearing that he likes his guys to look good. It looked like he was adjusting Randy McKay's jersey for him just to make sure he was TV presentable.
You know.
It's not how you feel.
You know. It is far better to look good than to feel good. You know who you are. Back in behind the net, Morrow. Morrow looking to center it, had it taken away and cleared up to Sergei Breland. Breland moves it out, Niedermeyer up. Niedermeyer, the offensive defenseman. Shot deflected, McGillivray. Couldn't redirect it on net. Gomez stepped up, went by him to Keane. Two on three the other way. Block, Niedermeyer. Niedermeyer and Ken Danico. Constant defensive pairing. Devils with the advantage in shots and chances now. Set back in, Matvichuk takes it back in behind the net. The clock continues to tick with 6:14 to go, and nobody's got one to the back of the net yet. Hatcher up for Keane. Hatcher gets booze every time he touches the puck after that shot he put on that we were looking at in the last game. Down low, the centering pass to Hatcher. Hatcher a wrister, deflected out front. I think hit Danico in the back. Hatcher takes his man down, and the puck rolled to center. Eliash, Sikora, Arnott all there. Referee wants him to play. Keane won't let it free. Finally got battered away. Sidor sends it in. He'll chase it down himself with Dallas changing up. Sidor centered. Blocked. Held in by Yuri Lehtinen. Lehtinen, oh, did he get taken down? Pitchfork. Hang on. How many? He took a stick right up in the chops.
That was one of those confusing group. I mean, it was a group of players together, and the way I looked at it was kind of confusing. It was almost as if one of his own players' sticks could have got torqued in between a couple of other guys. But he got hit with the face, and Dan Marinelli is sending a Devil off. Gerald Sidor is all right. So the Stars breathe a sigh of relief. Here's what it looked like.
Dallas got a break here.
Yeah, they did. Watch what happens here. I mean, the stick of Yuri Lehtinen. There is the stick of Yuri Lehtinen. There is the stick in the face of Scott Niedermeyer. And it was Lehtinen that lifted Niedermeyer's stick right into the face of Sidor, so that's what I was looking at. But a break, actually, for New Jersey, because Sikora is not a penalty killer, and Niedermeyer is.
Niedermeyer does kill penalty. So does Pandolfo. Tried to clear, could not. Here's Sidor, chance. Madonna was in front, but it got blocked. Sidor took the high sticking at 14:23. Second power play of the game, intercepted by Madonna. Second chance on the advantage for Dallas. Sidor got it down low. Hall shot that one right through the crease, had no angle. Madonna again, back on top to Zuboff. Zuboff, rifle shot, deflected in front, still loose, not clear. Sidor again, shot wide. Dallas firing every moment, shot. What a save! What a save! What a save!
Lehtinen can only exhale and go, I cannot believe he stopped me. That is twice now that Marty Brodeur has been down for the count. But he's never really down for the count, is he? This is why you shoot from the point. Even the wide shots are dangerous. It came right out to Lehtinen. He tried to get it over Brodeur, but Brodeur, watch. He'll kick out. He'll move out towards Lehtinen to try to cut down the angle. Then he stacks and spreads. We'll see where he got it here. I think he got that one on the top pad, did he?
What put it in the glove. Then put it in the glove. Right off the pad into the glove.
See, that is why, and Zuboff is shooting. The Dallas Stars power play has one thought. You can tell. Fire, fire, fire from the point. Zuboff is shot already. Surprised. And Darryl Sidor's shot there. That is why you have to shoot from the point, even if it goes wide.
They hold it in. Sidor again over to Madonna. Power play for Dallas. You saw New Jersey hasn't given one up at home this year in the playoffs. 0 for 22, the opposition. Cleared up and up. You don't get many power play chances against the New Jersey Devils. They've averaged just about 8 minutes in penalties per game in the playoffs. So if you get them, you better take advantage of them. They're few and far between. Brodeur loves to handle a puck, clears it out.
What a play by Brodeur. He knocked the puck out of midair behind the net, controlled it, corralled it, turned around, rifled it down the ice.
50 seconds left to go on the power play. Zuboff moves it in. Zuboff near side. No attack save made. Martin Brodeur. Cleared up. Devil short-handed. Here they come. Love you. He's got Nemchinov. Couldn't get it there. Niedermeyer backhander. Deflected off Eddie Belfour. Later on to the far side to Madonna. 30 seconds left to go in the power play. Madonna, Sim is open, doesn't take it. Left at Madonna, cutting shot. Deflected off the glove and wide. Martin Brodeur at the angle on it. Madonna was waiting for a rebound, but never got it. Sim moves in. Sim centered Hull, jumped over his stick. Cote joins the play, the defenseman down low. Only one man back at the blue line. Sim again. Madonna, power play, 7 seconds. And it's cleared by Matt.
The Devils dodged a bullet there. Claude Lemieux was dead on his feet, could hardly skate, and he got caught out there. He also dodged a bullet because he cross-checked Brett Hull in the head and knocked his helmet off and didn't get called.
Penalty is over, 0 for 2 in the power play. Dallas and New Jersey keeps their perfect mark of penalty killing in the playoffs at home in line. Hard shot, Sikora, and the linesman far side down, but is all right. I'll tell you, you got to keep your head up no matter what color uniform you're wearing out there in tonight's game. As Scapinello, Jay Shear is our linesman, and there have been some shots set in. Malakoff at center, loose penalty coming up. Here's the whistle, high sticking call. Gary Lettinen without the helmet out there, and arguing is Eliash. Yes. I think Lettinen's got the Gary, penalty.
I thought it was on Eliash because he went over and really took Lettinen hard, but he was screening Lettinen from my vantage point, and apparently Lettinen got his stick up.
2 minutes, high stick.
Eliash went for Lettinen, and Lettinen tried to protect himself by getting a lumber up. Watch this. Eliash comes from the right here. Tried to take him. Got the stick up. He must have nicked Eliash on the way by, but then Eliash roughed him up on the way down. That could easily have been coincidentals.
Well, Dallas got a power play and a call that, if the officials looked at it in slow-mo, wouldn't have called it at all, probably. Now Yuri Lettinen, penalty that little iffy at 17:01.
Got to be so careful, though. I mean, everybody has to be so careful. So much at stake. This is what I was talking about. Lemieux was dead on his feet. Look at that. Cross-checked Brett Hull on the side of the head, knocked his lid off, then went back to him and cross-checked him again and dodged the bullet. I think anybody saw that.
Claude Lemieux is not known as one of the nastier players to be up against without just cause. Sikora back. Devils get their second power play. 0 for 2 in the power play in the game for Dallas. Lettinen out, 17:01. So the Devils have the full length of the penalty if they need it. Eliash intercepted Hatcher. Hatcher will move that one out through center. Oh, the Dallas Stars penalty killing unit back to work. They've given up only 2 and 11 chances to the New Jersey Devils. Near side Hatcher had it knocked down along the wall. Sikora's got it. Sikora, Rafalski, Sikora over to Bobby Holik. Holik's pass deflected in towards the net. Jason Arnott. Arnott came back to the point. Sikora. Sikora. Dallas coming out, challenging the puck here. Trying to find a man open. They do. Bobby Holik, save, rebound. Hit the side of the net.
Gracious.
Eddie Belfour on Bobby Holik, who has had a couple of, oh my gosh, chances in this game.
Can't believe he missed this one, too. Bobby Holik, I think, is in shock right now. All right, Dallas killing the penalty aggressive up high. As soon as you get the puck down low, you've got a 2-on-1. That's what happened. Holik cutting in, what a save by Belfour. Not only the first one, but the rebound. The fans here erupted because they saw puck on twine. But it was on the twine, not in the twine. Bobby Holik, I'll tell you what, there's a big, big emotional challenge for Bobby Holik right now because he knows he could have been the difference already in winning the Stanley Cup. And we talked about how the pressure was on the Devils because they know the cup is in the building. Dallas is saying, hey, we're not supposed to win this whole thing anyway now. The Devils know they're supposed to win it. Bobby Holik, that's why he was getting talked to there, saying, keep going, you'll get one, keep going.
Malakoff back over to Niedermeyer. Power play has got 1:03 left on it. Claude Lemieux's on it. That was blocked on the centering pass by Eddie Belfour. Martin Brodeur holds it up at the other end. And back to get it, Malakoff. Malakoff and Niedermeyer along the blue line. Lemieux, Gomez, McGillney on the power play up front. Shot in, deflected, and rolls out of the zone off Hatcher. Short-handed Madonna. Madonna a blast wide, not close. That went through the top of the crease. Gomez got it up. Lemieux looking. McGillney hollering for it. McGillney waiting for help, trying to get Gomez on the near side wing. He goes back on top to Malakoff under his stick and down the length of the ice. And the power play down to 22 seconds left on it. Played back by Malakoff. Malakoff sees the time, tries to hustle it up to the red. He'll dump that one in. Behind the net, Belfour will play it. Belfour around the wall, knocked down by Gomez. Centered for Madden. Deflected. Malakoff steps up, put the bump on Keane, and didn't get the puck. 1 minute to go in the period, and the power play is over. So both teams 0 for 2 on the power play. And 50 seconds to go in the second period. It is scoreless here in game 5. Zubov knocked it down for Sidor. Into the middle. Guy Carbono got tied up. Jammed at. Madden did the defensive work. Puck off Madden. Zubov picks it up. Zubov had to turn it out in a hurry as he got challenged up ice. Good work here on the forecheck by Randy McKay. McKay goes over to meet Sidor in reverse direction. And Zubov up the near side boards and out. Stevens. Stevens chipped it the other way for Jason Arnott. Arnott got around Sidor, but not far enough to stay up. 18 seconds left to go in the period. And this could be an icing call here. That'll benefit the Devils with a faceoff. All right, Max Life storyline, Game 5, Stanley Cup Finals. 13 Cup Final games since 1944 have been scoreless after 2. We may add to that. 25 teams have led the Stanley Cup 3-1, and 24 have won the series.
Our Max Life replays, you will have Max Life as a hockey team if you can get saves like the kind Marty Brodeur has made in the second period. Phenomenal goaltending. Point blank, Yuri Lendl on the last one.
Martin Brodeur has made 17 saves. Eddie Belfour has made 18. At home, 25 wins, 17 losses in his career in the playoffs here. You keep seeing that 1-9 number, goals against. Shot on, deflected, Bobby Holík up to Matvichuk, got a piece. 6 seconds to go, still time to get one lined up. They can hold it in. Yuri Lehtinen tried to block it, got it out of there. And Stevens will handle it, and the horn goes off. We have completed 2 periods of play. Yuri Lehtinen that close to giving Dallas a 1-0 lead, but that close is not enough. We'll have the Dodge different intermission. It's coming up. Al Michaels and company after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Third period at the Meadowlands where the score is zip zip. Question is, in a game where the Devils can wrap it up, third period no score, benefit Dallas?
Gary, I think Dallas has trouble sustaining. They have had in this series. They did in game 4. They came out with a 1-0 lead. You combine that with the fact the Devils seem to have a killer instinct. I don't know, unless that trend reverses, the Stars, I think, have a problem here.
All right, shots are 18-17 in favor of the Devils. And here we go. Third period underway here at the Continental Arena. Sent in, Stevens back to get it. Stevens will work it out near side. Devils win, we'll be here for the Stanley Cup presentation. If Dallas wins, we'll be in Dallas Saturday night for game 6. Far side, Nemchinov. Nemchinov taken away by Madonna. Madonna's centering pass just deflected to the boards. Bobby Holík, Lemieux tipped it away. Here comes Rafalski. Rafalski and save. Lemieux followed it up. Stick picked up as he tried. Rebound. Belfour knocked it away. Nemchinov, the trailer, deflected that in on Eddie Belfour. Both teams change it up straight down the middle hull. Poke checked away. Nemchinov on the turnaround shot blocked. Rebound ripped. Sim missed the net. Played in Matvichuk. That one blocked out deep. We start like a house of fire in the third. Both teams charging up ice, trying to get that elusive first goal. Played behind the net by Martin Brodeur. Sergei Zubov leading Dallas in ice time, just under 17 minutes. Niedermeyer, Scott Stevens, each over 16 for New Jersey. Fireside, Hatcher had it, kicked away. Elias comes to the near side wall. Played off the boards, Jason Arnott. Couldn't be controlled by Sikora. Hatcher, Elias do battle. Elias dug it out, centering pass, Matvichuk had it, still does. Matvichuk and Jason Arnott. Tipped away to Hatcher. Devils good pressure here to keep the puck in on the forecheck. Near side wall, Niedermeyer stepped up and held it in again. Niedermeyer trying to get it down low, couldn't. Came back on his stick. Guy Carbono lost it. Center, Elias, the move, the backhander into the pads. Rebound, shot, never got it to the net. Danico, that was Niedermeyer following it up. Elias, centering pass, tipped just wide. Jason Arnott with a chance. And it deflects up and onto the bench.
God.
amazing stuff. Look at Ken Hitchcock. He can only smile at this. Great play by Niedermeyer at the blue line to keep this play even alive. And then when the play moved out to Elias, what a move he put on. Then he got it to Niedermeyer, who had pinched in low and it handcuffed him. He couldn't get a stick on it. Guy Carboneau came in and took him out. Look at this. Ed Belfour, you know what? What's amazing here? Ed Belfour appeared to never lose sight of the puck, even though he was flat on his back. He knew exactly what to do with his right arm. Just amazing stuff.
Actually, there never ended up being a shot in all of that.
But that's why the Devils have more scoring chances than the Dallas Stars, but the shots are irrelevant, you know?
Yep.
And that's why we track different things.
Different games, different meanings. That one came outside the line, and that will be whistled on the offside. Just underway, third period. No score, game five. Let's check in. One of our men downstairs, Darren Pang. Darren.
Well, Gary, you love the Ryder Cup. You love match play. We've got two goaltenders right now that there's an awful lot of pressure on them sitting at the 18th hole. Freddie Belfour, he is as desperate as he could possibly be. All the pressure really is on him. He's in a situation where there is no tomorrow if they lose this hockey game. He told me this morning, what do you think of a 1-0 hockey game? It may very well take that, fellas. He and Marty Brodeur have both been putting on a wonderful goaltending clinic in this hockey game.
Martin Brodeur, in games where there's a chance to eliminate the opponent in the playoffs, is 9-6. Eddie Belfour, when facing elimination, 7-6 in the playoffs. Knocked away to center. Sent in by Gomez. Eddie Belfour comes out to play it. Held it up for Manson. Manson around the far side. McGillney reached in, could not get it. Thornton up ice in the middle. There he is. Tips it in. Neuendijk's line is out there again. Hit in the face. Colin White. There's no call. White is down.
Oh,
rebound shot, and that block. He blocked it. It hit him. Colin White was down on the ice, had no idea where the puck was, and it was shot right into him. No call. There has been no call on the stick Colin White took, and I don't know who hit him.
Colin White doesn't look like he has any damage either. I think Dan Marinelli and Don Koharski are smart not to call it unless they're absolutely sure. So much at stake here, especially for the Dallas Stars, because they're on the verge of on the brink of elimination. That was Scott Thornton that was trying to get around him, and he got his stick up and kind of got him in the face. That could have been called had it been seen, but it's kind of a gentle tap. Yes, it might have qualified in the third period of a 0-0 game in the Stanley Cup Finals.
Rookie Colin White slamming her down over there, wanting the call, didn't get it. Devils win the draw. They've not done much of that. 61% of the faceoffs have gone to Dallas through two periods. Cleared around by Belfour. Back to Lemieux. Claude Lemieux, big game player, looking out in front. Shot. Lemieux looking for a rebound. It never came through. Lettinen blocked it. Rebounded Nemchinov. He dropped it. Holik shot. There was Lemieux. He gets hit in the face. And Zubov caught him. As Zubov reached in, trying to pick up his stick, and Lemieux will stay out there. He's not going anywhere. Still out on the shift. Puck hits him along the near side boards, tied up with Yuri Lettinen. But Lemieux's got to be careful up here not to get a frustration penalty. He banged away at Lettinen as they came off the boards. Oh, what a shot put on by Stevens again. He got home. Scott Stevens. Here's Lemieux still out. Lemieux needs to get to the bench. He dumps it in and heads there. In the corner, Belfour let it go. Elias played it. Trying to hit Jason Arnott. Arnott goes back. Got the puck. Jason Arnott. Arnott flipped it in. Shot. Belfour the save. Elias with a chance. And Eddie Belfour knocked it down. Rebound Dallas coming the other way. Looking. Lyashenko. Rolled in but not on net. Played around by Kurt Muller. Jason Arnott. Up for Elias. High off the glass. Not out. Hatcher held it in. Devils get it right back. Jason Arnott. Wheels. Shot in from center, bouncing puck. Belfour will hang on.
What a tilt. What a tilt for the goaltenders. Ed Belfour now is trying to match Marty Brodeur in spectacular saves. Patrick Elias had room. And there are also hits here in the third period. You got to know Scott Stevens is going to be the guy dishing out the hits. There's the backhand by Arnott. And Belfour was actually over, square, in the butterfly. I mean, Ed Belfour has made the real difficult saves look routine, and that tells you that he is really on top of his game. Big hit by Scott Stevens. All you need to do is lose the puck for a second in your skates. He'll be there to get you. And this happened a couple of shifts ago. Guy Carboneau and Scott Stevens going at it.
A tremendously intense game, as you would expect. It is nothing, nothing. We are 4.5 into period number 3 of game 5. In behind the net, Brodeur cleared it up. Stepping up, Carbono had it, lost it along the wall. Played back out by Madden. Pandolfo leaves it, shot in by Niedermeyer. In behind the net, Belfour played the deflection. Off the dasher, Madden near side. Knocked it down, centered McKay. McKay's looking out in front. Wrap around to Mapichuk, can't get it to the point. Danico. Danico back, Madden comes in to play it. Madden taken out of the play. Guy Carbono stayed with the puck. Madden looking, Pandolfo in front. Centering pass blocked into the corner. And Guy Carbono will move it out. Morrow on the other side, Niedermeyer in front of him. Danico will chase down. Danico gets it out to avoid any pressure offensively, and Keane will flip it into the corner. Niedermeyer off the boards for Gomez. Freeland there first. Freeland could not clear. Deflects off a Devils player to McGillney. Alexander McGillney turned off the puck. New and done. Gomez reaches in and finds it. Dishes back. Niedermeyer. McGillney. Manson in front of him. Hit Manson with the puck. Niedermeyer. Couldn't control that. Cleared out Neuendijk to Sim. Sim with Thornton cutting. And that one's blocked. Niedermeyer got back. Got a piece of that on the block. And they'll wave off any ice. Cote back to get it. Ferocious pace. You want to have the game-winning goal. You do not want to create the mistake or turnover that results in a goal to the other team. And that's why the pressure continues to pile up with every ticking second. Dumped in off the boards. Here's Colin White back out on the ice. White chased down by Yuri Lehtinen over to Malakoff. Hull moved in. Got the puck around. Hull Lemieux cleared it out. Good pass by Claude Lemieux. He'll leak the trailer. Shot deflected and into the seats. Nemchin off the chance. ABC's coverage Saturday of the 125th running of the Belmont Stakes. The final jewel of the Visa Triple Crown. Saturday, 4:30 Eastern, 1:30 Pacific on ABC. For more, log on to abcsports.com. ABC's exclusive coverage of the Stanley Cup Finals, the Continental Airlines Arena. Those of us here, just happy to be. You don't think we're fans enjoying this game? Think again.
It's the best game of the series so far.
Yeah.
Because of the goaltending, because of the quality of the scoring chances. But true to form, the New Jersey Devils have come out here in the third. They're out shooting Dallas 4-0. They're out chancing them 3-1. And coming into the third, they were out hitting Dallas 28-10. That trend has continued. Scott Stevens has had 3 hits himself here in the third period. So, can the Dallas Stars sustain? If any Belfour holds, all Dallas needs is one good shot and they can force a game 6. But if you think that there is an advantage to having the majority of the play go your way, and there has to be, the Devils seem to be on the verge of doing that again here in the third period.
Well, we said at the top, Bill, Eddie Belfour was going to have to stand on his head, be spectacular. So far he has been. Fans wanted a too many men on the ice call. Madonna was just coming over the boards when he touched that up. Belfour drops it for Hatcher. Hatcher leaves it. Mapichuk in behind the net. Mapichuk looking. Hull took Arnott down. Arnott took one look at the referee. Koharski said a word and then said, oops, I better get back into play, and did. And was he who broke that up at center. Rafalski in. Rafalski. His shot. Save made. Belfour. And there'll be no rebound.
Hearts are beating fast now. I mean, these players know what's at stake. The majority of these players have dreamed at one point about getting their names in the Stanley Cup. Some of them already have their names on the cup multiple times. Brett Hull last season, Joe Neuendijk twice, Scott Stevens in 95. Can they do it one more time?
Euro Martin Brodeur shutting out the Stars. And you talk about hearts beating fast. How about that, Bill?
I think he was looking up at his family. That's his wife, Melanie, on the left. Their 3 sons, Anthony and the twins, Jeremy and William, taking it all in with their Texas-looking hats. What's wrong with that picture?
Those are the good luck hats. Morrow intercepted it. Morrow centered for Keane, deflected behind the net. Gomez has it. Gomez over for Breland. Hatcher will step up. Moved around him. McGillney's on the other side. Niedermeyer has to chase down the puck. Niedermeyer in and whistled. McGillney was already in the zone. Offside.
Dallas is starting to gamble now, and they just about got caught in a 2-on-1.
No score in the third period. Next Saturday, June 17, hard hitting. Stevie Johnston defends his WBC lightweight title against Jose Luis Castillo. Exclusive interview with Oscar De La Hoya as he prepares for his upcoming fight, the WBC lightweight championship, next Saturday live at 5 Eastern, 2 Pacific.
Well, we've played almost 7 minutes of the third, but you have to go back to the second period with about 3 minutes to go for the last Dallas shot on goal. They have not had one now in 10:27. That's what I was saying. They just have not been able to look like a team that can sustain in this series. The Devils have taken it away in the third.
Devils clap it down. This is going to be whistled on an offside, I think. No, touched up by Brodeur. It's going to be an icing call waved off. Jason Arnott got it up, cleared back in Sikora. Belfour out to play it. Belfour around to Cote. Wants to go up the middle with it, trying to hit Neuendijk. This will be an icing call if Malakoff gets there first, and he does. 12:45 left in regulation in the third.
You want to play it tough, but you got to play it smart. Watch this. Grant Marshall with a cuff to the side of the head on Colin White. White took him down cleanly, but then Grant Marshall said, come on, what's that? What's that? That was a right cross, Grant. That looked like a pretty good hit. It looked like he just gave him a push in the chest. And everybody has to be careful. Grant Marshall, Colin White, as you mentioned, Gary, everybody wants to be the hero, but nobody wants to be the GOAT. And guess what? In a 0-0 hockey game, we'll probably have one of each.
Yep. Off the faceoff, one back by Dallas. Another huge advantage in this game in that department as Madonna won another one. And cleared into the corner, Yuri Lehtinen, beaten by Stevens, over to Nemchinov. Nemchinov with Claude Lemieux back out, Lemieux in the middle. Bobby Holík, chances Holík has had in the last two games and has not been able to get one home. Zubov tying him up. Nemchinov, Lemieux, Holík on this line. Near side boards held in by Rafalski. Back to Nemchinov, the Sarge as he is known. And picked up by Hull. Hull moves it out 2-on-2 the other way. He'll drop it back. Madonna joins the flow. Left it. Shot on, deflected. Lehtinen had the chance. Rebound near side wall. That's why the shots stay down against the Devils. They block shots as well as any team in the NHL. Both their forwards and their defensemen. Turning it. Napachuk talking about shot blockers. He had to take his man down over there. Breland had it, lost it. Napachuk still tied up with Holík behind the play, and that flip's going to go off the glass and onto the Devils bench.
Where is the leadership going to come from to get this done? Well, you'll take it from anybody, but the guy is wearing the C's for captain. You have to look to, especially Darian Hatcher. We focus on Darian Hatcher, the first American-born captain of a Stanley Cup champion. Brother Kevin plays for the New York Rangers, played for Team USA in the 96 World Cup of Hockey. Boy, would he love to bring the Stanley Cup back to the suburbs of Detroit, Livonia, where he grew up. Kind of interesting. Somebody might bring it back because Brian Rafalski's from Dearborn and the Devils are on the verge of knocking out the Dallas Stars. And it'd be interesting that the Cup could be back in the Detroit area without the Detroit Red Wings taking it there.
Yeah. And for Hatcher, he's had just one assist in the last 15 games. He's been their leading ice time man with 24 and a half minutes a game in the playoffs. Napachuk dumped it in, trying to spring somebody loose. Sim, Neuendijk took the knockdown. Neuendijk, Thornton, Sim, Neuendijk cutting, block, Neuendijk, wraparound, right there with a stick in hand. Martin Brodeur with a goaltender stretch.
Make a wish. Talk about the splits. Joe Neuendijk executed, I think, what you can call a perfect wraparound attempt. Look at Melanie on the left there, lower left. She can't watch. She turns her head away. Watch this. Joe Neuendijk, and right there on the backhand, he was perfect. He had it out front. Look at Brodeur's splits. Watch the stretch here. That is why goaltenders have to be the most flexible athletes on the continent. Check it out. He had his skates post to post.
The first Dallas shot in 12 minutes and 18 seconds was almost goal number one. 6 points, 16 games in the finals last year. Joe Neuendijk had a big playoff year. 11 goals, 10 assists in the playoffs, plus 7 this year. 7 goals, 3 assists, and a minus 1. Shot, Manson wide. Manson got a pretty good chance. Kurt Muller landed on Brodeur. He's back up, shot, deflected. Brodeur got up a little slowly after Kurt Muller ran into him. And that will be whistled.
Well, that kind of splits it. He's flexing his leg too now, Gary.
Brodeur did look a little awkward. Kurt Muller got in front on him, and Brodeur gingerly got up and then didn't move very much.
Not moving much right now either. And he's shaking his left leg in there. He's keeps flexing his left leg. You never know, having not done the split since he warmed up before this period started, and all of a sudden having to do it like that, bang. I mean, you know that there's some stress there on tendons and muscles.
Ote a chance. He had to knock that one away with a blocker. They got a stick out there to keep Kurt Muller away from him as Muller went by. There's Muller, former Devil, trying to center in front. Shot! Grant Marshall denied. Brodeur.
Well, he looked fine on that one. So we'll forget about any problem with his groin. Grant Marshall, a guy that has been in and out of this series. Mike Modano, double shifting, out there with two sets of wingers, and Marshall couldn't get the first one off. And this movie isn't going quite the way Melanie Brodeur wanted just yet. No, she can't watch the scary parts. But Marte is under the gun. That qualifies as a Friday the 13th scary part for Melanie. Marshall did a good job of getting the second one away, but the first one bounced over his stick, and that would have given him the best chance to beat Brodeur.
Marshall has never had a playoff goal. Cleared in Zuboff, deflected in front, held on to Stevens, actually got that one caught in his jersey. Down to 10:46 to go in this third period of game five, no score. Everything you would want for Bob Gainey, the architect of this Dallas team. They want to take it back Saturday for game six. Their GM, he and Lou Lamoriello, two GMs who have put these organizations together on the ice. And what a job they have done with it. Jersey Devils trying to win their second cup, winning one in 95. This is only their second time in the Stanley Cup final. For the Dallas Stars, 23rd playoff in their franchise history, fourth time to the finals. Won it once last year. Up the wall and out. Zuboff couldn't reach it. Sedor stayed back. Bobby Holik up on the forecheck on him. Lemieux moved in on Neuendijk. Neuendijk to the red, blue and in. Trying to wind up. Lemieux wouldn't let him get turned around. Stevens in behind the net. Stevens up the near side. We are midway through the third period without a score. Neuendijk held it in for the moment to Hall. Hall wanted a one-timer. Trying to find room. Dodge blocked. Didn't have anywhere to go with it. Knocked down in play. Shot. Save made right off the chest. Lettinen with a chance.
Oh, what a backhand shot by Yuri Lettinen. And the Dallas Stars have stabilized, and they are coming on. And I'll tell you one of the reasons why. Oh, Claude Lemieux with a right shot to the face of Joey Neuendijk. And I don't think it's going to be called. But one of the things that's happening is the New Jersey Devils are now conceding their blue line to the Dallas Stars rush. That is not a good sign for the Devils, but it is a great sign for the Dallas Stars, and that's about as good a backhand as you're going to see from anybody in the NHL. Lettinen uses a straight-bladed stick just about, and that's one of the reasons he can backhand him like that.
Mm-mm-mm. U.S. Open coverage coming up Thursday, 5 o'clock on ESPN, the 100th U.S. Open Golf Championship, and Pebble Beach is the place. Tiger will be there, so will Jack Nicklaus. It'll be coming up on ABC on ESPN. Taken away by Danico, cleared it up. Hatcher at it, lost it. And played by Belfour. Matvichuk back in behind the net. 9:50 to go in the third. Look out in front. Almost. Sikora was reaching in for it. Brendan Morrow dumps it in wide. Niedermeyer back to get it. Niedermeyer trying to get it off Delios. Partially blocked. Up the near side wall. Carboneau blocked it. Niedermeyer back in behind the net. Delios at center. Niedermeyer was looking for it. No room. He'll bring it up himself. Sends it in. Dumped out, Keen off Arnott, stick to Danico. Danico's got one goal in the playoffs. Waited a long time to get it. Thought about shooting it, but dumped it in instead.
Smart
near side. Yeah, Sikora got it. Sikora sends it back. There's Matvichuk with it. Belfour looking. Nowhere to go up center. Devils drop back into the middle here. Hatcher's got it. Both teams change on the fly. Hatcher trying to feather it in. Knocked down Niedermeyer. Taken away again, Hatcher. This time he makes sure. Centered in high off the glass. Modano up. Modano center. Didn't have anybody there. Dallas was changing behind the play. They didn't have anyone on the ice. Intercepted. Cote back. Manson with it. Manson to Cote. 8:47 to go in the third. Stevens will give chase and behind his own net. Thornton moved up on him. Thornton missed the check. Near side Modano held it. Manson fanned on the attempted shot. Here's Gomez. Gomez coming. Gomez with Breland. Gomez. Shot blocked and it's cleared by Dallas. This is Stanley Cup playoff game five.
and is coming real close to qualifying as a classic from a goaltending standpoint because of the quality of the saves that both Brodeur and Ed Belfour have made. Eddie Belfour with the latest great one on Scott Gomez. Gomez on a two-on-one said, "I'm a rookie. I can be a hero." If only he wasn't in there.
Broadcast coverage of tonight's NHL game brought to you by the Bud One Airship. Bud Light, the world's best-selling light beer, the official sponsor of the NHL. Thanks for being with us, everybody. ABC's exclusive coverage, Stanley Cup Finals. Wow. Javi Olic in the draw, and we won back by Madonna. What a game. What a finish, no matter what. With 8:16 left to go. Guaranteed now. Olic along the near side. This Dallas team has had to battle back after giving up three third-period goals in a matter of 3.5 minutes on their home ice. Coming back here after a two-day wait, time to think about it. They've come out rocking and ready. Knocked down by Madonna. Madonna to Hull. Hull, dangerous, dropped it in the middle. Shot wide! Yari Lehtinen. Love you. Lehtinen got tied up from behind by Stevens, so he did not have a clear shot. Sidor waits. They get onside. Dallas changing. In behind the net, Rafalski takes it. Kirk Muller moved up, then backed off. Rafalski waiting as the Devils change. Bobby Holik. Holik wide. Played over there by Eliash. Eliash sends it in. They'll complete their line change here. Near side, Kirk Muller. Muller wide of the net. Off the side of the net. Brodeur played it. Near side intercepted. Muller shot. Save. Rebound. Right into the crease. Sakura was just standing there. It'll be run up ice to Eliash and whistled on the offside.
Well, Larry Robinson is using the same matchup that he has all game against the Mike Madonna line, but now Lehtinen, Hull, and Madonna are starting to turn it up a notch. The Bobby Holik, Claude Lemieux line has been matched, as well as Scott Stevens, for almost this entire series, at least the defensive part of that. And there was the miss by Yuri Lehtinen that just skipped by. I don't know if the interference from behind helped a little bit. Those are hard to execute, the one-timers that come across your body.
The Devils know, because against Philadelphia, they became the 16th team in history to come from a 3-1 deficit and take a seven-game series, just the 16th. They know it can be done because they did it. They don't want Dallas turning the tables on them. That one is whistled on the offside, 7:06 to go. Darren.
Well, we've been monitoring Melanie, and this looks awfully, this is painful for you, isn't it? You can barely stand to watch.
I can't take it. I'm working. I can't do it.
Any superstitions? Kissing the kids? I know you got them all here.
No, as long as he waves at them, we're fine. I just want it over.
Good luck. Keep that towel ready.
And Matt Pichuk sends it in. Held on to by Key. Oh, Carbono put the hit on the far side on Sergei Braylon. Brought up in Niedermeyer. Niedermeyer centering pass. Gomez almost. Gomez and McGillney were both there. But Dallas D got back. Danico behind the net. 6:40 to go. Regulation. Looks like one goal is going to decide this one. McGillney into the corner. Gomez. Gomez right back up. Nieuwendyk on him. Gomez turns. Breland with him. Knocked away. Nieuwendyk. Tough play. Nieuwendyk comes to the middle. Gets around McGillney. Joe Nieuwendyk, MVP of the playoffs last year, player down, and a penalty on Dallas, and it had to be called because it freed up the Dallas offensive man for a scoring chance.
Wow. That is the reason Scott Niedermeyer fell on the play. If Niedermeyer doesn't fall, maybe it doesn't get called. Brandon Morrow had just been smoked by Sergei Breland with a big hit at the other end. Then came down, and all he was trying to do was create a little room for Joe Nieuwendyk. He created a little bit of room, but he did it illegally, according to Dan Marinelli. There's Morrow right in the dead center of the picture, and he gave Scott Niedermeyer just a little poke in the knee. Whether or not that was enough to throw Niedermeyer off and to make him go down, we may never know. But it was enough for Dan Marinelli to call.
Tripping at 13:45, the third power play of the game for the New Jersey Devils. They are 0-for-2 in this, 2-for-14 in the series. No score with 6 minutes plus to go in the third period. That'll be sent in. and left it near side. Bobby Holy. Holy turns it back into the corner. Elias Arnott coming over to get it. Bobby Holy will set up in front. Rafalski holds it in. Back to get it. Hatcher looking for room. Their captain had it blocked by Holy. Rafalski leaves it. Sergei Breland. Sikora's up on top here with Rafalski. Near side Elias centered all the way through. Sikora's shot blocked. Sikora held it in. Bobby Holy. Elias in front now. Jason Arnott looking. Dallas staying back in the box. Tightening in the middle. Shot. Sikora deflected. Near side. Dallas gets it back shorthanded. Madonna. Madonna looking. They just changed. Shorthanded. Kane save made by Brodeur. Mike Kane had just come off the bench. Power play continues. McGillney's offside as he lost control of the puck. 52 left on the power play.
Oh, great kill so far by Dallas. And a good scoring opportunity here. What's interesting is Mike Keane's shot was actually in the air, and the guy that he was replacing wasn't even off the ice yet. You've got to know the Devils would have objected to that. And here is Jason Arnott trying to get the power play established and crushing Richard Matvichuk in the process. A couple of shifts ago, oldest man in the NHL at 40, Guy Carmono just toasted Sergei Breland. The great thing about this game is that the intensity and the hitting, if anything, has picked up as the game has gone along. It hasn't dropped off a bit.
So much at stake in the Devils. There you see the hits that have been lined up in tonight's game. 5:07 to go. 52 seconds remaining on the New Jersey power play. During the regular season, the Devils had the third best power play in the league and the best home power play numbers in the NHL. But Dallas had the best penalty killing unit ever. In behind the net, Malakoff. 40 seconds to go in the advantage. 4:54, he fanned in the attempted out. Malakoff coming. Niedermeyer's got it. Niedermeyer dumped it in for Lemieux. Hatcher got it and sends it out. Can't get it set up. 25 left on the advantage. Malakoff again in behind the net. He and Niedermeyer along the blue line. McGillney, Lemieux up front with Gomez. Gary Lettinen knocked off the puck. Gomez has it. Gomez leaves it. McGillney back to it. Gomez a little room. Gomez a shot. That's deflected. Eddie Belfour standing up straight ahead. That one bounced right across his mask. Played by Gomez down low. Lemieux set in the middle. Penalty is over. Niedermeyer backhands it in wide. They do not score in the power play. 0-3. We're down to 4:05 to go in the third. Madonna moved it in offside. 4:02. Regulation. Devils win. We see the cup. Dallas wins. We go back to Dallas. Great night here for hockey fans. 1 mile away, Grasshopper also is the name of the establishment. Carlstadt, New Jersey's the place. They've got their foil cup on hand, hoping to hoist it.
As long as it can hold champagne.
4:02 to go in regulation. 24-22 the shots in favor of the Devils. What matters now is a goal for somebody. Hull couldn't hold it in. Bobby Holy. Holy trying to go around. Zuboff couldn't get there. Breland got the puck, but it goes off the Dallas bench. Whistled with a face-off coming in center.
Bobby Holik and his line mates can do some business if they get the puck deep into Dallas' zone. Daryl Sador and Sergei Zuboff are not as big, they're not as strong, but they're quicker, and they move the puck better. It's been a great contrast in seeing these two styles go at one another in this matchup, with Zuboff and Sador pretty well playing against the Holik line for most of this tilt.
Dan Hitchcock of Dallas, 42-26. Playoffs 15-10 for Larry Robinson. He had never beaten Hitchcock as a head coach until they got here to the finals. Now, trying to put the cup away. Malakoff shot skipped wide. Ever so dangerous shots from center because they bounce. Played back into the middle to Lemieux. He couldn't get it. Hatcher will pick it up. Keep an eye on that clock as it ticks away here in the third period. Colin White behind the net. Fire side, pinching up, Neuendijk. Got it into the middle. Hall blocked. Malakoff blocked it. Hatcher got it. Hatcher got Lemieux down. Shot blocked. Holik. Holik coming. 3-on-2 for the moment. 4-on-2. Lemieux trying to move it in along the wall. Hatcher got a piece. Holik gets it. Centers hit the side of the net. Holik, backhander save. Rebound. Covered up. Bobby Holik is going to have Belfour nightmares forever if they don't put this series away.
No kidding. No kidding. Bobby Holik, though, continues to look like a guy that is going to get chances as long as this game is played. His centering attempt hit the side of the net, came right back to him, and look, daylight opened up. He came out, got not only one, but Ed Belfour got just a little chunk of the rebound with the tip of his stick. First one he got with the pad, the second one Ed Belfour nicked. He nicked it with the stick, and it went right into his own glove. Now Bobby Holik saying a little prayer over there. We talked about a goat. I don't think you can call a guy a goat just because he hasn't scored, but Bobby Holik could have won this game four times already.
Elias got it back in the middle, tipped in behind the net by Sikora. Jason Arnott out there at center on this line in the middle. Sikora! Side Belfour! It was a puck that took a New Jersey bounce, and it deflected right onto Sikora's stick. Stevens back to get it. Tied up by Yuri Lehner. 2:48 to go in the third. Zuboff a shot. Goes behind the net. Kurt Muller came over. Rapolsky stepped in. Lettinen had it, lost it, and it goes to center. Chased down by Zuboff. Out there with Sidor. Modano. Near side Sidor. Flipped it up in the air. Intended for Keane. Goes into the Devil's bench. Whenever the Stanley Cup can be won, it is obviously in the arena. And there it is. Lord Stanley's Cup. 14th game, scoreless after two, this one. Previous 13 games, the team scoring first has won 11 times, and there have been four overtimes.
Well, one is going to win this one, Gary, you said it. I hope the players for both teams have their favorite overtime juice ready to go in the locker rooms, because the way Marty Brodeur and Eddie Belfour have played, we might be looking at more than one overtime period. Just wanted to prepare everybody, get a little snack ready.
Niedermeyer dropped it off. Kenny Danico came back to get it. Over to Niedermeyer on the near side. McGillney up the wall. McGillney at center will flip wrong side of the red, though. It'll go on goal, so there's no icing. And play behind the net. Hatcher. The pensive crowd, quiet, watching, waiting. Danico chases down in his own end. 2 minutes to go. Regulation play. Freeland tipped it out of there. Again, there'll be no icing. Eddie Belfour has to play it. Got it off. McGillney up in the check along with Gomez. Played up by Hatcher, not out. Gomez held it in. Couldn't control. Intended for Morrow at center. Icing call. Will they wave it off? No. Face off back in Belfour's end.
Well, we mentioned that Larry Robinson, the coach of the Devils, looks out and doesn't see these kids as rookies, even though Scott Gomez is one. You get to this stage of a hockey season, look at Gomez. Right in through the crease, upended Eddie Belfour with his skates. Right here. Now he looked away to make sure that everybody knew that was an accident. But you know where you're skating, and you know when you're deep inside the paint of an opposing goalie. So, a veteran play there by young Scott Gomez.
All the folks in Alaska watching their man right there, Scott Gomez. They're just in time for supper if we go to overtime. That one taken back in behind the net. Up the near side for Yuri Lehtinen. Rafalski drops it off. Jason Arnott's in the middle. Eliash goes down. Puck comes free. Not going to get a call with a minute 28 left to go unless it is absolutely obvious. Zuboff trying to get it in. They would have been offside. Devils able to clear it back up. Eliash trying to move around Zuboff. Cannot. Hull. Modano. Lehtinen line out there. Jason Arnott turned it into the middle. Backhander was blocked by Hull, played by Sidor, into the zone and knocked down. There'll be no whistle. Both teams over the bench on changes. Eliash has it. Eliash sent it in. 1 minute left to go in regulation. No score. Third period. Barton's got it. Barton. A Devil's goal in the Stanley Cup will be theirs. Neuendijk. His shot deflected to the near side. Lemieux. Claude Lemieux picks it up. Lemieux leaves it. Danico. Danico sends it in around the boards. Bobby Holik up to hold it in. Did. Lemieux goes to the corner with Hatcher. They battle. Neuendijk sends it around. Danico will step up. Marshall took him to the wall. Off the near side boards. Here's Niedermeyer. Niedermeyer helped hold it in. Bobby Holik a shot. And Eddie Belfour through a screen. Marshall and Nemchinov. Neuendijk's got it. 20 to go in the period. Knocked down. Niedermeyer waiting. They clear. Niedermeyer from center. Belfour knocks it down. Hatcher will play it. We're down to 11 to go in regulation. Morrow trying to get around the D. Blocked. Again, McGillney. He lost it. Mavichuk clears it out. Brendan Morrow trying to get it around Stevens, but it goes onto the bench. 2 seconds.
2 seconds.
We have good chance we're going to OT here, William.
See, that's the thing. We can't get anything by you, Garrett.
Our Dodge Different intermission report coming up.
Oh, Bobby Holik, I'll tell you what. I mean, if you were going to pick a deserving player on either one of these teams to end the game, you got to know Bobby Holik is deserving. Yuri Lehtinen has had great chances. Brett Hull has worked his tail off in this hockey game. So has Mike Modano.
What an effort has been made, and we will go to OT. This series has not had an overtime since 1927, when the NHL took over the Stanley Cup. This is the seventh finals game to go into overtime with the score 0-0. We will be coming back. We go to overtime here in New Jersey. Welcome back, everybody. Gary Thorne, Bill Clement. Well, I mean, there are no secrets. There's nothing left that these teams don't know about one another. It now becomes a wonderfully pure who wants it, who gets it.
And which goalie can continue to make those big saves. The one thing is, if this overtime situation wears on, Mike Modano's already played almost 25 minutes. That's defenseman-type minutes. He's going to wear down at some point because Mike Modano's minutes are tough minutes. The Devils have used their bench, I think, a little, I wouldn't say better, but a little more widely than Ken Hitchcock has used his bench. And as a result, I think the Devils will have a little more jump depending on how long this thing goes. However, the first 8, 10, 12 minutes of the first period, I mean, fatigue is not a factor. Everybody is in on this.
Martin Brodeur, Eddie Belfour. Brodeur is 3-10 in overtime playoff games. Eddie Belfour is 16-14. In overtime playoff games. The next goal wins. It is that simple. So we start the overtime period. 27-22, the shots in favor of the Devils. Stanley Cup has been won in overtime 14 times, and it wasn't long ago when Brett Hull in Buffalo in the early morning hours put one home to win.
And if he finds himself in the shooting hole off a faceoff in New Jersey's end, there's a good chance the puck will come to him. Dallas has dominated New Jersey on the faceoff, and that could be a factor here as well. I mean, you look, every guy is having trouble for New Jersey winning.
Jason Arnott dropped it back. Near side for Stevens. Hull has 3 playoff overtime game winners. Down the middle, Modano will take it after the back check poked it away. Lehtinen, Modano, and Hull. Lehtinen for Hull. Stevens is there. Knocked it away to center. Tipped to Sikora. Sikora, Eliash. Eliash near side. That's hit with a high stick. Dallas can play it. The Devils can. And there's the whistle on it. We are just underway in the OT. For the New Jersey Devils in overtime in the playoffs, 6 straight overtime playoff games they have lost. The NHL record is 8.
And you know why you try to hit in a hockey game is to try to wear a team down. Scott Stevens tries to wear everybody down that he plays against. At age 36, though, sooner or later, he will wear down. But he didn't show any signs of fatigue in the third period. The Devils about hit the Dallas Stars in regulation in this hockey game 41-15.
This is where these faceoffs Bill was talking about become so vital. Bobby Holik will try and draw it back. But it's won again by the Stars and cleared out. Neuendijk won the draw. Chased down for an icing call at the other end, and we'll get it right there. These two franchises, Dallas 19-24. Playoff overtime, New Jersey 5-15. Ken Hitchcock said even before the game, we haven't got any secrets, there's nothing more. We just got to be ready. Play a spectacular game, Belfour has.
Have to be really smart here now in overtime, not to overstay your shift. Not only will you just burn up a lot of gas and whatever fuel you have left in your body if you overstay and overextend, but it's tough to change. This is just like the second period. It's the long change. Your bench is a long way off when you get tired.
Another face-off win for Neuendijk. Hatcher trying to send it out, blocked by Holik. Off the near side. Nieuwendyk came back to get it. In into the middle. Nobody there to touch this one up. It goes in behind the net and not touched. Sim, good play. Sim kept it alive as he beat Colin White, but White came back to free it up. Hatcher takes it. Lemieux there. Claude Lemieux. One of those you look for in a game like this, as he has picked up three game winners in overtime in the playoffs. Malikov will touch this one up for the whistle. ESPN's coverage of the U.S. Open. It begins on Thursday at 5 on ESPN. The 100th U.S. Open, Pebble Beach. Nicholas, Davis Love, and Tiger Woods. Tiger has already won there earlier this year, and Nicholas said if you got to play one course in your life, this is the one. ESPN's got it Thursday at 5 Eastern.
You know, I mentioned the shift length and making sure you don't get caught on the ice. We also point out there aren't any television timeouts. You don't take any breaks, any commercial breaks. So if you overextend and you're a key player, you might not have time to recover for your next shift on the bench.
That is important, Bill. We've talked to the coaches about that during the season. They coach knowing TV timeouts come about every 5 minutes, and they plan their rotation around it. When you get into the overtimes, that's gone. And that's what you're talking about. Be careful.
Exactly. In other words, you can take a guy like Mike Modano, and if you know at what point on the clock the television timeout is coming, you can double shift him. You might even be able to triple shift him, knowing that you're going to get a couple of minute break, and then somebody else can take a shift. So you get three and a half, maybe 4 minutes for Mike Modano to rest. You don't have that opportunity in overtime.
And the faceoff again won back. E. Carbino won the draw. Dallas continues to dominate on the faceoffs. McGillney trying to tie up Morrow. Carbino's over there. Kicked away by Gomez, who sends it in. Belfour back to get it. A packed house on hand. The OT underway. This is the seventh overtime this year's playoffs. Back to get it, Morrow. Niedermeyer tied him up. Puck loose in behind the net. E. Carbino centered right through the middle. Just missed Keane. Held in by Manson. This will be the eighth OT. We've had seven already this year. This is number eight. Could be the one that ends it all. For the Devils, a chance to capture the cup. Shot by Carbino. Glove save by Brodeur. Imagine the pressure on these goaltenders where you're down knowing you have no leeway. One goal ends. Carbino had it blocked. Niedermeyer trying to send it around. Blocked again. Up the wall. Morrow held it in. Morrow had it bounce. Keen shot. That'll go up and over the glass off Kenny Danigo.
Boy, great shift by Guy Carbino's line. Great shift. Well, Sergei Breland wears number 18 for the New Jersey Devils. We hope that he has practiced a very key Stanley Cup move since they won in 95. He didn't have the move down pat. There he is. They were counting down the clock. Billy Guerin was beside him. Away went Guerin, and down went Sergei Breland. And he recovered to join the pile a little late, but nevertheless able to celebrate.
A piece of Stanley Cup history.
In fact, it's a Stanley Cup off-the-bench jump.
Off this face-off, Rafalski as Jason Arnott won the draw. Looking in behind the net, somewhere to go. Sikora plays it up. Dallas back to get it. Zuboff and Sidor defensively. Sidor, Modano out there. Langenbrunner and Hall. Tipped in the middle of Modano. Left it for Hall. Poke checked away to center by Arnott. Played by Elias. Elias trying to move around Zuboff. Zuboff has had his best defensive game here. He has been outstanding positionally. Poke checking, checking. Near side, Jason Arnott got it again. Near side to Sikora. Sikora looking. Elias is on the other wing. Can't get it there. Played around by Belfour. Sidor up. Arnott under his stick and out. Got a wave off the icing here. Jason Arnott could have touched it. Rafalski had to play it. Stevens got the tip out by Eliash. Good tip. Bobby Holik. Holik chance. Save made. Bobby Holik. Bobby Holik leads all shooters with now six shots in the game.
But you know what? I like his decision there to wind up and shoot. Yeah, there was somebody coming late on the trailer, but if you misfire on that pass, Dallas has gone the other way. This is a sign that Bobby Holik hasn't been rattled by the fact that he has missed countless number of good scoring opportunities in this game. Anybody that had lost all confidence would have passed there for sure. He took one look, had an option, decided not to take the passing option, and let her rip.
He has had scoring chances as well, but Eddie Belfour has denied them all. Face off, Lemieux will move in to take this for the Devils against Joe Nieuwendyk. Colin White back on the near side. Looks like he wants to draw it over to Vladimir Malikov if he can on the backhand. But Nieuwendyk the faceoff again. Boy, Joe Neuendijk is just piling up the faceoff wins. He's gone 13 out of 20 through the regulation three periods. Eric Muller looking. Muller jammed up. Melikoff in the corner. Puck still there. Muller got up to find it. Melikoff had it in his skates. Lost it. Marshall set up in front. Neuendijk around the back of the net. Neuendijk forehand. Tried to center. Blocked by Colin White. White takes Neuendijk. Tries to out of the play. Finally dies. Lemieux got it. Lemieux looking. Nemchinov's ahead of him, but was covered. Brought in by Holik again. Holik down the wall. Holik in front. Holik rolled. Carbono. Nemchino took him out of the play. Here comes Niedermeyer. Niedermeyer in. Niedermeyer wraparound chance. Belfour blocked it. Hatcher blocked it. Centering pass blocked by Muller. Niedermeyer backhander blocked by Carbono. E. Carbono got it out. Oh, oh, oh. Yeah, baby. Oh. Right off the post.
Isn't any good, is it?
Hit the inside of the post and came.
I don't think we've got anybody watching nodding off right now.
Back in it comes to Cote in behind the net. Intercepted. No. McGillney blocked it once. Cote got it back. McGillney still up. Cleared out the center. Bounces off Stevens. Played back by Danico. 5 minutes into the overtime. No score. Sergei Breland bounced up in the air. Everybody jumped up for that rebound. Morrow got it, sent it in. Stevens right back out. Stevens in the middle. Couldn't connect. McGillney chasing. Cleared back up. Manson onto the Devils bench.
Time to catch your breath. For all of us, Darian Hatcher included. Bobby Holik knew that he had Grant Marshall back, so he decided to take a shot at him. He got all the way around him. Oh! That had enough steam just to get over the goal line. And Darian Hatcher, right here with his long reach, had it been a Devil, just a one-handed swing, and the game could have ended. Oh. As Melanie Brodeur is saying, I can feel your pain, but it would feel so good if it went in.
And that wasn't even a shot. That puck just bounced off people in front. And it hit the post. Top of the circle draw in the Dallas end. And Niedermeyer and Neuendijk won another one. Neuendijk ripping off the faceoff wins here. Powell back to it. Deflected off into the boards. Rapalski. Neuendijk up in the check to try and hold it in. Paul joins the play. Jason Arnott with a puck to Stevens. Stevens has got Eliash on the near side. Trying to get it to him. Didn't connect. Chased down. Eliash trying to avoid the icing. It did. Patrick Eliash. Big time play right there. But the Devils can't control. Here comes Hull. Hull moving it in. Off the boards. Yuri Lettinen. Rapalski blocks the centering pass behind the net. Rapalski up the near side. Eliash got it. Dallas changes. Eliash moves it in. Jason Arnott in front. Dropped it off. Sikora shot. Save made. Belfour. Rebound near side. Tipped by Sikora to center to Hull. Hull moving. Dallas changing. Hull in. Malikov takes him down. Malikov with a puck. Hull's at the end of the shift. Just lost the edge. Near side to Stevens. Stevens looking in the middle. Couldn't find anybody. Came free. Madonna kicked it away. Malikov the same. And Lemieux will backhand that one in. Nemchinov, Matvichuk, new battle. Treat the puck up, Holik. Again, Bobby Holik. Holik backs it in behind the net. Lemieux, he's got Hatcher on him. Lemieux, forehand side, dished it off. Belfour comes out to beat Nemchinov to it. Thornton's got the puck. Thornton cleared it up in the air. Still in the zone. Nemchinov held it in. Eddie Belfour is going to play it around. He had Holik giving chase. Near side, Hatcher didn't get it up. McGillney ripped it wide. A turnover by Darian Hatcher, but McGillney shot went wide. Colin White. Let her rip, boys. Holik to White.
Check out the round of applause here. I mean, huge ovation. I'm not so sure it's just not for the great hockey game.
That's perfectly acceptable here.
You bet.
Niedermeyer back to get it. We are 7 minutes into the overtime. No score, 29-23. The shots in favor of the Devils. New Jersey, if they can get the goal, will win the 2000 Stanley Cup. Dallas, if they get the goal, will send it to a game. Here comes Madonna. The shooting gallery's open. Taken down by Stevens.
And that's
hard to the wall.
That's the right term, Gary. Taken down. And Mike Madonna appears to be shaken up, but he was actually taken down by one arm wrapped around his waist from Scott Stephen and crashed to the ice.
Modano's still in the zone. That's the offside whistle. Modano got up and he's skating, but very slowly. I think Stephen's almost broke him in two.
What a shift. What a shift. I mean, there was. Where do we start? Well, let's start at the end of the shift. There's Stevens with the arm. I mean, that's an amateur wrestling takedown. And Mike Modano went down hard on his shoulder, real hard. And here's Brett Hall, open on the side. Why? Because Scott Stevens had pinched right to the front of the net to try to end this thing. And just about picked up the pass to scoot it by Eddie Belfour. And that's why Hall had an open lane down the side, because Stevens was behind him.
Oh, with four shots in the game, Scott Stevens continuing to match up as he has all five of these games against Mike Modano. Modano on the bench. We'll keep an eye on him. And his next shift comes up here. Neuendijk on the faceoff. Devils won it. Holik shot in. Brodeur knocked it down. Chance from center. Colin White. Darian Hatcher takes it back in behind the net. Seats still full here at the Continental Arena, New Jersey. Devils fans hoping to see the Stanley Cup paraded tonight. Dallas hoping to take it home for a game six Saturday. Malakoff around the near side. Neuendijk got it. Shot deflected, blocked by Colin White. 2-on-2, Lemieux and Nemchinov. Lemieux swings it in off the boards. Belfour back to play it. Bobby Holik steps up. Holik freed the puck up. Back to Bobby Holik. Holik being held here. Holik looking. Holik on the backhand side, turning, shot wide. Lemieux was down low that time. Hatcher for Matvichuk goes back to Hatcher. Where you start seeing some of the mistakes here with tired players. Centering pass, Malakoff, and he ripped it wide. Niedermeyer back for Bobby Holik. Holik's got Lemieux in the middle. Lemieux went by it, and it's cleared off the boards. Malakoff held it in, taken away. Muller. Muller trying to make a turn. Sim, Hatcher, shot. Chance to take it home. Shot, Hatcher again. Ran it right into the middle, and Niedermeyer hit his body. Lemieux cleared it. Nobody there. Manson. Devils were caught changing. And offside.
Oh, a break for the Devils. Oh. Martin Brodeur. Point blank. Under the gun with Darian Hatcher closing in. Martin Brodeur's wife, Melanie, during the quiet moment. This was not a quiet moment. Hatcher looked, had time, went for the short side. Brodeur's form was there. The blocker right there, the right-hand blocker, bang, got him. All right, this is a stressful time. I think her son is actually telling her what happened, doing play-by-play for her.
And this faceoff won by Gomez. Mike Modano right back out on the ice as we thought he would be. So he did not miss a shift after that hit by Stevens. Sent in wide. And Manson plays it around the board. Marshall's got it. He will back up a little more now because they're tired. There'll be a little more ice at center than some of these rushes. McGillney got it. Sent it into the zone. 41-30 the shots in favor of the Devils. And McGillney dropped it in. Way offside. It'll be a free out here in the delayed call. They won't need it. Modano played it up. Rafalski picks it up. 14:23 to go in the second overtime. Off McGillney skating in. Gauthier cleared it up. Let's recap the scoring. Now that we're done with that, over to Rafalski. Rafalski sends it in along the near side wall.
We don't have a sponsor, do we?
No sponsor. It wasn't time to get the sponsor in.
All right.
Brought back up by Yuri Lettinen. Lettinen cleared it around the far side. Hall couldn't hold it in. Zuboff off the board, Sedor. Dallas clears the zone. Again, shot from center. Brodeur knocked it away. Eliash with Neuendijk on his back. Neuendijk poked it deeper. Played back Jason Arnott and Rafalski. And Stevens had it blocked by Yuri Lettinen. Sikora cleared it up. Way up in the air and out to center. And Dallas wants a change here. Sedor will gain the red in front of him. Malakoff got it. Here's Bobby Holik. Holik moving in. Chance. Missed it. High, but he got it up. Tip pass away to Morrow. Morrow, Devils changing. Just on the ice, Lemieux ran him off the puck. Third fireside, Nemchinov intercepted. Morrow to Modano. Modano a wrist block. In front, Colin White. Morrow got it back behind the net to Keane. Keane leaves it there. Keane heads to the front, pass to him, partially blocked Malakoff. Fireside Nemchinov had your stuffed up, held it into Keane. Morrow can't touch that one. Colin White. White trying to cut through the middle, can't. Here's Keane. Keane dropped it. Madonna for Keane. Keane, backhander. Save Brodeur. Rebound. Madonna covered.
The lucky red jacket just about came through for Mike Keane and the Dallas Stars. What a scoring chance. Colin White had tried to make a good out. It got stopped at the blue line, and they came back. There's another makeshift line by Ken Hitchcock. It was Brendan Morrow, Mike Keane, and Mike Madonna. Mike Madonna has been a constant. The drop pass, then into Mike Keane. Can he get it? No, Mike Keane took the shot, and Marty Brodeur stoned him, and then Madonna came around and got a pretty good shot at the rebound. Watch this. Right there, sharp angle. But I'll tell you what, it might just as well be one of those from behind the goal line that caroms in off the goalie or off somebody's skate. And it's interesting, when the goalies play this well, teams don't do that. We haven't seen anybody just go wide and try to throw one of the goalie's skates.
Face off, one again. Sim, shot, deflected high. Cote held it in. Neuendijk won yet another draw. Neuendijk got up slowly after the faceoff win. Cleared around by Danico and out. Wave off the icing, I think. Nope. Cote back. He'll touch it up, and there will be a whistle. 12:35 to go. Second overtime. If Dallas wins this, there will be a game 6, 8 o'clock Eastern Saturday. If a game 7 is necessary, right back here Monday. ABC has it. And all games preceded by Quest for the Cup, 7:30 on ESPN.
Who is going to be the hero? Could it be Randy McKay? He is just trying to stay limber because he has not had a shift in overtime. But there is a precedent for a guy coming off the bench in OT coming up big. Peter Klima in 1990 playing for the Edmonton Oilers against Boston. Sat for almost 3 full overtime periods on his first shift. He ended the game.
Amazing.
Randy McKay could be that guy. Who knows?
Neuendijk, who won 21 out of 30 through the first overtime, did not win that. Reach for it, Manson. Knocked down. Taken by Kurt Muller. Cleared back up. Pandolfo, Madden. Out on this line, they've not seen much ice time. Neuendijk, Pandolfo in the middle. Freeland under his stick. Here's John Madden. Madden flips it in. Belfour coming out with Freeland moving up. Off the boards by Madden. Here's Niedermeyer. His shot into the screen. Freeland a backhander rolls in. And covered by Eddie Belfour.
Freeland just couldn't get loose and couldn't get his body turned around to get anything on the shot. So he just kind of limped one to the net. But this is the kind of shot that wins in overtime. As a matter of fact, from that spot is where Huey Krupp scored for Colorado. And I remember like it was yesterday, but it's those screen shots. There is Freeland. He really couldn't get twisted around. Take a screen shot if you have it. Sidor really did a good job of keeping a stick between Freeland's legs so the bottom half of his body couldn't follow the top half for the shot.
Sergei Freeland. 14 times the cup has been won in an overtime game. Longest 0-0 was the 96 game in Florida, won by Colorado. Cleared around by Zubac. Not out. Hull knocked it down. Could not clear. Devils hold it in. Down the middle. Score a shot block. Sidor. Sidor in trouble getting it on the tape here as Arnold was on it. Madonna's line back out with Howell and Yuri Lettinen. Played by Rafalski. Hull on the intercept. Couldn't turn it in the zone. Stevens pushed it away. Scott Stevens with Sikora. Arnott in the middle. Jason Arnott gets it. No. Block picked up by Madonna. Hull's on the right. Madonna down the middle. Rafalski played the man. Stevens took the puck. Rafalski trying to dump it in. Got pinned up by Thornton. That would chuck the intercept. Madonna's pass intercepted. Here's Lemieux for the cut. And it's blocked. Thornton knocks it down. Did not go through. Thornton tipped it away. Marshall. Malakoff had it. Marshall down on the ice. Held it in along the boards. Lemieux tipped it off the center. Ian Matvichuk battling for it. Holik kicked it away. Bobby Holik. Malakoff leaves it a little deeper. Colin White. Trying to get to the red. Couldn't. Hatcher blocked it. Still loose over there along the boards. And the Devils come back to get it. Dallas changes up. Claude Lemieux. Devils changing. Nobody out there. So he'll send it into the corner. Manson back to get it. Madden's line comes back out here. Near side, Sim kicked it out. He lost, Morrow did. He lost his stick. Sent back in by Gomez this time. That's a stick down on the ice right there. Brendan Morrow who lost it. Niedermeyer held it in. McGilley trying to get a shot. Morrow partially blocked it. He got a stick from the bench. Rebounded up on top. Danico Arista. That's deflected wide. Hatcher again back. It's by that broken stick and clears it out. Here's Keane. Leaves it. Tipped away Danico. Danico's got a man up ice. Here comes McGilley. McGilley shot. Save again. Eddie Belfour. McGilley and a breakaway.
Oh, and his first shot on goal. Alexander McGilley's first shot on goal, and it was a partial breakaway that could have ended this. Oh, gracious. Bam! 10:03 to go here, and you know what? The chances just keep coming. Great play by Danico. He made sure he wasn't offside by getting the puck across his own blue line. And then Alexander McGilley took the shot. Belfour out in front of the paint, making sure he cut down the angle. McGilney looked like he was trying to go to the glove side, but if he was, he didn't get it high enough. His first shot of this hockey game, and it came 90 minutes in.
We are midway through the second overtime, 10:03. 43-32, the shots in favor of the Devils with the Continental Arena. For Devils fans, up, down, up, down. Knowing that if one goes in, they get to celebrate the Stanley Cup championship. They've tried to do that about 100 times so far.
Well, the hockey wise men have always said the fourth game is always the most difficult one to win. The New Jersey Devils now believe the wise men.
That's why they're wise. Rafalski off the near side. Zakora, Jason Arnott, had it knocked down. Eliash. Couldn't control. Manson cleared it out. Sim coming. Madonna in the middle. Sim deflected wide. Kurt Muller out there now with Sim and Madonna on this line. Near side boards. Eliash has it. Scores in the middle. He'll send it in. Devils need a change. Back in behind the bench. Changes have to come in a hurry. Sim just got pushed into the bench over there by Sikora as they were changing. On the line change. That one gloved down and out. Bobby Holik. Holik to Lemieux. Claude Lemieux. Charging in. Lemieux. Down goes Cote. Down goes Lemieux. Puck behind the net. Sidor. Darryl Sidor got it up. Out of the zone. A little too far ahead to be played. Locked at center. Stevens has to take it back in his own end. Malikov got it up to Lemieux. Lemieux leaves it. Near side. Nemchinov down the middle. Tied up. Cleared back out. Two off to Hull. Waiting for help, finds it, nope, offside, New England.
How are we doing with those overtime records for the longest scoreless final game? I think we're climbing. Time marches on. We're number two. And we still have our eyes set on 104-31.
You do, huh?
I do. We're going to be number one. We absolutely are.
Brett Hull has had such a magnificent year in the playoffs. Faceoff again. Won by Dallas. Madonna won that one. Apachuk. Stevens. Cleared it back out. Into the middle. It's intercepted. Matt Tkachuk got it right back out to center. Scott Stevens played almost 33 minutes through the first overtime. Intercepted. McGilley gets onside after Breland had it. Couldn't control. Stevens again out. Stevens near side for Rafalski. Back over to Stevens. Gomez line up. Gomez ready to get it to McGilley. Block. Hatcher got it up. Grant Marshall. Marshall sends it in. In the corner. Thornton Stevens. Center for Marshall. Madonna trying to get a handle on it. Sent it into the slot. Nobody was there. And out of the zone. It was cleared by McGilman. Taken back by Darian Hatcher. Dallas. They need a line change here. Shifts now down to 25 seconds, maybe 30. They don't want to be long at all because that's when you're going to get burned. You stay out there too long.
I'm not sure that a lot of guys were capable of even staying longer than 35 or 40 if they wanted to now, if they've got a big tempo shift.
Tip back in by Brendan Morrow. That's what Bill was talking about. You get a guy like McKay who hasn't played. He's the fresh of the fresh over there, and you throw him out there, and all of a sudden he's flying by everybody. Sent back in. Sakura dumped it into the corner. Sergei Zuboff over to get it. Zuboff up the far side, and Keane flips it out. Brendan Morrow, Danico, punches him in the face. Cleared back. Sakura's got it. Jason Arnott in the middle. Sakura to Arnott behind him. That got blocked by Sidor. Back to Sakura. Sidor takes him out of the play. Zuboff over to get it. And an odd man rush for a moment during a line change. Sent back in offside on the Devils. Delayed whistle. Three out here. Dallas gets to move it out of the zone. And they do. That will nullify the whistle. And into the corner. Touched up for the icing call as Niedermeyer got back.
Oh, after a free out, too. Icing.
A reminder, stay tuned for your local news and Nightline over most of these ABC stations.
Well, it doesn't matter if the older guys are out there. They seem to have as much energy as the young guys, and Ken Danigo is in the senior citizen category of hockey players. Look at this, standing up Brendan Morrow. And that side of the ice is tough, because when the puck comes along the boards for Danigo or Stevens or for the right D, check the snow out that's collecting where the guys go on and off the ice. During regulation play, we have TV timeouts, and guys come out with shovels and clean up the sideboards and around the nets. But here in overtime, they don't want to stop play long enough to bring him down the front of the bench. So as a result, for all of the defensemen that play that side of the ice, when the puck comes up the boards, it's rolling, it's bouncing, it gets stuck in the snow. It's an adventure.
Just what you need in game five. And behind the net, Neuendijk has it. Neuendijk shot, deflected by Brodeur to save. Centering pass for Neuendijk was behind him. Bobby Olley drops it back to Malakoff. Malakoff has a cannon shot. Malakoff sent that one in, and it'll be covered by Eddie Belfour with Lemieux giving me a snow job.
Check that out, huh? And that was intentional, too. Claude did the real jabbing stop. That wasn't just a normal stop.
He's trying not to smile.
That is Claude Lemieux. Watch this. Watch how he turns and jabs. Boom, right there. I mean, he was going right for him with the stop. Eddie might be saying, you know, thanks a lot. It was getting kind of warm inside this mask.
Eighth all-time in playoff goals with 80, and as we said, he could become the only NHL player ever to win a cup with the same team, the Devils, after he won another with another team in the middle, which he did with Colorado. 6:17 to go on the clock. Great to have you with us here on ABC. That's Randy McKay, the man who's not playing. Darian Hatcher is.
Roman Lyashenko has not played for Dallas either, but as a rookie, doubtful Lyashenko, I think, will play unless this thing goes on and on and on. Ken Hitchcock is forced to give him a shot.
We've got 6:07 to go. Second OT, McGillney thought about breaking in. Matt Tkachuk poked it away. Back it comes, and a two-liner. Whistle. A reminder, Belmont Stakes coming up on ABC Saturday. Proudly present the 125th running of the Belmont Stakes. Final jewel of the Triple Crown, Saturday live at 4:30 Eastern, 1:30 Pacific on ABC. For more, log on to abcsports.com.
Ed Belfour had to be sharp on this last faceoff. Bang. And he's making them look. I mean, Ed Belfour has made every difficult save look easy.
Shots in the overtime. Devils with the advantage. In the second overtime, it's 8-6 in the second overtime. Here's Hatcher. Hatcher the wrister, blocked out deep. White got in front of that. Matt Tkachuk to chase down. In behind his own net. Had Pandolfo on in front. Pandolfo, Madden, and Breland on this one. Neuendijk got it. Nice pass out. Neuendijk can send it in. White back to get it. Thorne moved up on him. Tipped away. Straight up in the air. Not out of the zone. Malakoff again blocked. Malakoff got it ahead. Breland moves it in. Breland looking. Pandolfo cut it. Couldn't get it. Thornton on the far side. Thornton will move it. Devils are changing. They've got two back. Niedermeyer just come out. And there he is. Blocking it in front. Save made! Joe Neuendijk with a backhander.
Oh, man. Maybe too close. Joe Noondyke didn't have a chance to find any open net because he was real close to Marty Brodeur. But if there was a hole anywhere in Brodeur's stance, between the pads, under the arm, it had a chance. Marty's looking up. He wants to see this one, too. I thought this play was going to bog down because John Madden did a great job of back-checking to help Scott Niedermeyer out. It was only a really good effort by Scott Thornton that kept the play alive. There was Neuendijk, but you can see, unless he got it up high over the shoulder, there really wasn't any room through Marty Brodeur. But when you're that close, you don't have a chance. You just got to get it. You don't have a chance to look, to pick a spot. You just have to fire.
Neuendijk, three playoff overtime game-winning goals, one this year. Dono trying to draw it back. Got it to the top. Sedor leaves him. Here's Hull again. Hull, one time. Brodeur the save. Zubov shot. Brodeur the save. Hull shot. Walked into the corner. A sliding John Madden blocked that shot. Cleared up the wall by Aliash. Sedor back to get it. Sedor's pass. Went to center. Into the middle. Hull. Hull dropped it off. Yuri Lettinen blocked by Sikora. Stevens back. Eliash falling down. Got it out of there. And then wave off any icing. Belfour to play it anyway. Sedor takes it back in behind the net. 4:40 to go. Second OT. 45-36. The total shots in favor of the Devils. And incredibly, this game is still scoreless. Bobby Holy. Devils with a chance to win the Stanley Cup here in Game 5 at home. If they can get that one goal. Danico. Danico the high flip. Cote. Lemieux right behind you. Cote. Manson trying to cut off Lemieux. Cote moves it. Over the red line. Into the zone. Dished off. Shot. Brodeur save. Rebound.
Devils now have holes everywhere, and the Dallas Stars are coming at them. Dave Manson had both hands in the air. He was that sure this baby was in. Here it comes, and you see Dallas is just being able to come across. There it is, the shot. Brodeur with the blocker. Brodeur with the blocker. Amazing save. Mike Keane thinking of the red jacket the whole time, I'm sure.
Unbelievable saves.
What a save.
Both arms up at the blue line. Keane going for his third playoff overtime game one.
Dallas looks like they've got more jump now all of a sudden. They're the older team. And they've really taken over this game. And the New Jersey Devils are backing out and then giving them holes to come through the neutral zone. We'll see if this continues, but Dallas is looking like real fine right about now.
Eric Muller's got it. The irony of Bill, this is really the first time in this whole game tonight we've seen Dallas play this way. Right through the crease on a shot that was belt high. Played around. Hatcher moves over to hold it in and does. Dumped it in behind the net. Here's Neuendijk again. Centered for Sims. Batted up in the air near side. Kurt Muller. Muller's been moved up. He's playing a heck of a game. Niedermeyer shot. Neuendijk shot, rather, was blocked by Malikov. Again, Neuendijk's got it. Sims in front. Kurt Muller can't handle it. Near sideboard, Sims. Muller kicked it wide. Kurt Muller over to get it. Muller back. Neuendijk, Sims. Sims trying to center for Muller. Banged away by Colin White and out of the zone. Hatcher gets there, feeds it off the boards. McGillney dropped it off. Sim will play it. Both teams need changes. They don't get it here. Down they go. Shot Belfour, the save on Breland. Breland falling down. Got a shot off. Gary Lettinen drops it. Madonna got it ahead. Can't be handled by the Stars. Claire Propulski. Sikora's pass. Jason Arnott. Arnott in. Down the middle. Arnott trying to line it up. Sedor. Takes him behind the net. Centering pass. Eliash was there, but Hull blocked it. Hull dropped it off near side. Madonna. Madonna's got legs. Madonna moving, stripped of the puck. Gary Lettinen got it back. Hull goes behind the net. Got chopped at. Madonna the puck. Madonna leaves it. Hull. Hull side of the net. Brodeur covers.
The Dallas Stars are finding more and more time now, too. Time to make their plays and to stand around looking for somebody to pass to. Darian Hatcher takes away time and he takes away space like that on Sergei Breland. Then the play hooked around and stayed alive. Breland picked up his stick. And Darian Hatcher with a trip that wasn't called. It better be flagrant or it's not going to be called. It's as simple as that. Not now. And you know what? Players acknowledge that. You don't see anybody complaining about non-calls. They know. They know.
This game is going to be one, if at all possible, in a 5-on-5 set. 1:52 left in the second overtime. Draw to the right of Martin Brodeur. Comes off the near side board. Held in by Guy Carbonneau. Carbonneau lost it to Madden. Lost it tomorrow and got it back and cleared it out. Icing call. And there's the touch by Sidora with Pandolfo on his back.
John Madden is the guy being called upon by the Devils, by Larry Robinson, to win these faceoffs. But he's a checker by trade and a penalty killer more than anything. And when he does turn the puck up and ends up with it on his own stick, sometimes in his own zone, he's a little too firm with it trying to get it out. I mean, that's, you have to have kind of a scorer's touch at times as well, just to feather it down the ice. Brett Hull with a big torque on the stick. That one blocked, gone to the corner.
Oh. Madden had won only 37% of the faceoffs in this series, but he had been the best tonight of the Devils, who have not done well against the Stars. Mike Modano in against Madden. Manson is back on the near side point. Trying to get these players set. There's Manson right there. If he gets a point shot, if it's drawn back there. Modano couldn't control that. Madden got it to Stevens, up for Lemieux. Manson had him lined up, one-on-one. Cote back, Eliash the move, Eliash in. Lost control of it, turnaround shot, Madden blocked. Shot that right into Modano. Lemieux, circle. Lemieux trying to send it in behind the net. And Modano will get it out, repulsed.
You notice how quick Dallas is to move to their coverage when the Devils are deep in their zone? The Stars have way more time in New Jersey's zone to make their plays than the Devils do in Dallas' zone. That's how much sharper and how much more energy Dallas appears to have right now.
1 minute to go in the second overtime. Both teams changing it up. Set in. Noendijk. Shot. Save. Rebound. Right in the middle. Held on to it. Barred on the doorstep. Bounced up on Brodeur, but he caught it and held on.
That's why you throw them at the net, even if it's a sharp angle. We talked about how few players have done that. Larry Robinson knows his guys are back on their heel, and the Dallas Stars are coming at him. Joe Neuendijk wide, close to the goal line, about 3 feet from the goal line, rip it high. Look at Brodeur, his mask even flipped up. I thought I saw some cheeks. His mask flipped up because he threw himself up in the air to get this thing away from the short side, and then was able to cover it with his catching glove.
How about Colin White there, Bill, the rookie tying up Thornton? I mean, that's his job there. Clean out in front of Brodeur. If he doesn't, then Thornton's got a chance to whack at that puck when it's bouncing around. Don't forget, stay tuned for your local news and Nightline over most of these ABC stations. 49 seconds left to go in the second overtime. Face off back to Sidor. Trying to get a shot lined up, but sent it back in behind the net. Malikov cleared it. Near side, Sidor. Again, Neuendijk down low. Let it go. Malikov around. Breland. Brian's got the Gilney out there. Robinson getting some speedsters out. Bobby Holik moved it in. Whistle on the offside. 31 left here. For another OT. If indeed we need another intermission, our Dodge Different intermission report will be coming up. Al Michaels, John Davidson, standing by. All of our crew on hand here tonight to bring you this exclusive coverage of the Stanley Cup Finals. What a game we have with no score on the board. 45 shots for the Devils and 39 for Dallas. And the Cup is quiet in the sense. Regal Queens. You got to win the award. Back to get it is Hatcher. Hatcher backed it up far side. Breland tied up by Madonna. Hull. Not sure he really wanted to do that. Now they're going to wave off the icing. Anyway, so Brodeur came back to play it. Into the middle, McGillney. McGillney is flipped, knocked down by Madonna. Stevens back. 7 seconds left. Stevens will take it back in behind the net. He'll take one more long blast. And we will go to another OT.
So many good scoring opportunities for Brett Hull, for that matter. Countless number of opportunities in these overtime periods. But it is the Stanley Cup. It is what young players dream about. Dream about getting their name on. The New Jersey Devils have come very close to doing just that in these overtime periods. But then again, the Dallas Stars have come very close to forcing five.
Those are multi-overtime records, 3-4. Each team with each of these goaltenders, 4 losses. And we go, the New Jersey Devils. All of this, what they keep telling themselves is they can win the Stanley Cup here tonight. One goal. Dallas Stars, they've kept the heat on, played a great game, can take it home. Offside Madonna, that will be whistled, and we are underway in period number 6. Darren?
Well, the referees are very active as well, and they are mic'd for this hockey game. Let's take a listen to some of the action in the last overtime session as the goaltenders get some support from the referees.
What an exhibition goaltending.
Oh, where the goalie is! Know where the goalie is, Thornton! Crease!
We got a hockey game.
You got that right.
Don Morawski and Dan Marowelli.
There have been three power play opportunities in this game for New Jersey. A couple for Dallas. 0-0 still on the board. Near side went by Sim. Claude Lemieux picked it up. And cleared out of there. Nemchinov got it. He had to Lemieux near side. And Lemieux will send it in. Eddie Belfour went back to play it. Malikov stepped up. Puck along the boards. Played back. Napichuk got it over to Hatcher. Scott Stevens has played over 23 minutes in this game. Sim trying to clear it out. Cannot. And Sim gets it out on a second chance. He'll head to the middle. Too far ahead on the Muller pass. Kurt Muller reached for it, couldn't get it. Gomez. Gomez puts that one out of the zone. And Breland following it up. Matt Machuk cleared it around the far side. Taken by Hatcher. Bill and I were looking at faceoffs. They are amazing. Mike McDonald, 52 faceoffs in this game. And he has won 61% of them. Niedermeyer dropped it off McGillney. Cleared back out, intended for McGillney. Breland got it. McGillney crisscrosses. McGillney to the net, shot, blocker saved. Breland took the wrister, knocked down. Breland got it back in off Gomez. Breland again couldn't hold it, cleared out the center. Devils get back on side, Niedermeyer and Danico. Danico trying to move it up the near side wall. Bobby Holik has 8 shots, 3 of those in overtime. Hull's got 5, 3 in overtime. And John Neuendijk, 6 total shots, 4 in overtime. So the Stars, big guns have come on as the game has gone along with offensive chances. It'll be Manson back on the touch up for the icing call.
Mike Madonna came out in the first shift of this third overtime period. It looked like he was shot out of a cannon. Incredible stamina, Mike Madonna. Stanley Cup Finals fact, the 5th triple overtime game in NHL history. Road team has won the previous 4. Hear that in Dallas? The road team has won the previous 4. Through 2 overtime periods, Mike Madonna, 40 minutes and 57 seconds. Top ice time, guys, but this is amazing that a forward has more than the top defenseman.
Defensemen almost always lead a nice time, and Martin Brodeur hangs on. Morrow cutting in, was looking around for a rebound right into that glove.
This line continues to do really well, generating scoring opportunities. Carbon, O'Keefe, and Morrow. Ice time for the Devs. Scott Stevens, as you would expect, because he's matched up against Mike Madonna, 43-23. Then to Rafalski, then to Niedermeyer. Niedermeyer is usually the top ice time getter. Scott Stevens has logged a bunch. And as I said, that is because of how much Mike Modano has played.
43 and a half for Scott Stevens. And off the near side, Brendan Morrow played it. Morrow, after face-off win by Cravino, Eliash got it back. Eliash again tipped the center. Eliash had it. Morrow, they stay on side. And Devils trying to change it up. Madden had come out to take the face-off. And they send him off the ice against Sikora back out. Madden's been the only guy close to 50% on faceoffs.
And it really is going to possibly hurt the Devils, because when John Madden is out there, yes, he might win the faceoff, but then if the play stays along this side of the rink, it's tough to make that change and get Sikora back out there. So on the rush, the Eliash Arnold line is not nearly as dangerous.
That was Sikora had that last shot that was deflected. Niedermeyer gets it back. Devils are changing over there. Good move, Bobby Holik. Holik trying to center, tied up by Sidor. Back up onto the point. Held into Stevens from Rafalski. Stevens pass. Had nobody over there. Sikora lost control of it. Holik gets it back. Holik centers in front. Sikora. Shot blocked by Sidor. Sikora back to Stevens. Stevens open a blast. That's deflected. Nemchinov onto the back of the net. Dallas wants a whistle and they get it. Are there going to be more games in the Stanley Cup Final? If they are, ABC's got them for you. Saturday, Game 6, 8 o'clock Eastern if necessary. We will be back in Dallas for that one. Saturday, Game 6. If there's a Game 7, it would be Monday, 8 o'clock Eastern time right here on ABC. Quest for the Cup, 7:30 on ESPN. They'll come in, Gary Thorne. 3.5 minutes into the period number 6, third overtime. I tell you, not many folks have left, Bill.
It's wonderful to look up here and know that we're not alone at 1:10 Eastern.
You don't give up a chance if you're a hockey fan to see the Stanley Cup. And the celebration, if there's a win, that's what they'll get to see tonight if New Jersey can do it. Shot by what? Save made. And Hatcher picks it up, and he Belfour kicks it away. Out to center it comes. Marshall's on the right. Drop it to him. Marshall, Neuendijk shot, hit the side of the net. Claude Lemieux picks it up on the far side. Colin White giving chase. White tied up by a Hatcher and hard into the plexiglass. White win gets right back up. Loose on the far side. Thornton will chase it down over there. Trying to clear it out and did. Madden got a piece of that, so they're going to have to play it. Martin Brodeur moved out to get it. Pandolfo. Pandolfo in, shot McGillney, glove save Belfour.
Stanley Cup still standing by. In the event the New Jersey Devils are able to win, and you bet there's a spot right here. Right here for the New Jersey Devils. If they can get it done. But the Dallas Stars have gotten stronger as these overtime periods have clicked on by. Now it appears, here we are in period number 3, that the New Jersey Devils have regained the momentum, because they have been able to hem the Dallas Stars in their end.
Lord Stanley providing the cup to the Amateur Hockey Association of Canada, 1893. The inscription of names did not occur until 1908 on the cup. It used to be just the team name. Tip back out of the zone. Gary Lettinen lost control. Sikora set it right back in. Eddie Belfour back to play it. Cote around for Lettinen. Knocked out Sikora. Sikora tried to center. Lettinen blocked it. Modano had it taken away. Jason Arnott centering pass. Hole there. Got it away from Sikora. Over to Modano. And Mike Modano able to move it out. All in front of him as they move in. And whistled on the offside. Gary Lettinen. This is now a game of history. Huey Krupp in Florida, 0-0 game, 3 overtimes. Colorado, game winner by Van Beesbrouck. And the cup went to the Colorado Avalanche, who had Mike Keane and Claude Lemieux on the same team. They are here tonight playing against one another. Lemieux and Keane. There's the record.
Told you.
We have moved to number 1. So this is the longest scoreless game in finals history. And glad you are a part of it here on ABC. Zuboff sends that one in. Niedermeyer on the far side. Gomez out to center. Matt Kachuk just out on the ice. Will chase it back. Near side to Hatcher. Hatcher will have to flip that one up as Breland went sliding along the ice. McGillney to Breland. Great pass. Breland trying to move it in. Hatcher puck checked it away. Nieuwendyk. You do marvel at the mastery of these players at this point in period six to make do anything, much less the kind of passes that we've seen in these overtime periods. McGillney around, not out. Shot Matt Kachuk. Save made. That came all the way through. Wow. On Brodeur.
That either surprised Marty Brodeur or he missed it with his glove. He got it with the left pad. The Devils were in control, but when you rip it around the boards that hard the way Alexander McGillney did, your guy up on the wing can't get it. And Richard Matvichuk was over there and just ripped one back into to Marty Brodeur's crease. There's McGillney trying to get it up the boards to Scott Gomez, but he ripped it around really hard. Matvichuk with a good compact windup. That might have deflected off of one of his teammates, of one of Brodeur's teammates on the way. It looked like it nicked something.
And the faceoff will come to the left of Martin Brodeur. Reminder, stay tuned for your local news and Nightline over most of these ABC stations. Mike Modano, Zuboff back on the near side boards, trying to draw it back to him. Bobby Holik won the draw. And the Devils can start from behind their own net. Up off the far side to center. In case you were wondering, in that previous longest game, Patrick Roy made 63 saves. John Van Beesbrouck had 55 in that game that Ewing Group won. Tonight, we are not near those shots. As the Devils put up a total of 48. Stars 40.
We might not have the raw numbers of shots, but we have had countless number of spectacular saves, because in amongst all of those shots have been really, really good scoring opportunities. So Belfour and Brodeur have really shared the story in this game so far.
And they have shot in, deflected near side. Rapalski got a stick on that before it got to Brodeur. Stevens doing work in the corner with Lehtinen on him. Eliash poked it away, centered. Hull again trying to line it up. Rapalski slid into him. Wouldn't let him get a chance. In the middle, Yuri Lehtinen intercepted. Rafalski back. Rafalski cleared it up. Dallas trying to change. Here comes Nemchinov. Nemchinov in. Nemchinov centering past Lemieux. Lemieux battled. Got tied up with Manson and could not get his stick down on the ice. Poke checked away to Lehtinen. Hull's already up here in the blue. Hull trying to drop it in once. Twice! Score!
New Jersey Devils are stunned. The Dallas Stars are elated. This was not supposed to happen if you were a New Jersey Devil, but now the Dallas Stars have forced a game six. And who else but Mike Modano, the guy that has had more ice time than any other Dallas Star, just getting to the net with a deflection in front. And there will be another game, and there still is life. Scott Stevens got a piece of it, went right back to Brett Hull, an end over ender that banked in off of Mike Modano between Marty Brodeur's legs. Oh, we go back to Dallas. There is Mike Modano getting to the front, and he just got a little piece of it, and that is all he needed.
That is the first even strength goal in 10 games for Mike Modano. It is his second career playoff overtime game winner. Martin Brodeur has now lost 7 consecutive overtime playoff games. Why are they on the phone? The officials called the captain's over. I think there may have been penalties at the end of the game. That is a guess, but I think that was the case. Let's check in with Brian Engblom. Brian.
Gary, I'm here with Mike Modano, the star of the show right now. Mike, last year at this time, you played 3 overtimes. Brett Hull scores the goal to win the Stanley Cup. Now you score the goal in 3 overtimes just to stay alive. Which one's more difficult?
I think last year's was, but you know, when you're on desperation and survival mode, I think we just wanted to play smart. And
And we all said before the six that we've been in this position before. We kind of know what it is. We just wanted to pick away at it. We felt we were getting stronger and still had our legs. Our line was still jumping. So it's nice to finally get that over with.
Ken Hitchcock talks about energy and emotional level and the emotional fuel tank. Where is the fuel tank and what does it read right now?
Well, it's pretty going on empty. We're running on fumes right now. But, you know, with this is a big win. I think everybody feels a lot better. You get that rejuvenation back, and you feel lucky that we're going to see Saturday, and we can't wait to get home in front of our fans and see if we can go another day.
Congratulations, Mike.
Thanks, Brian.
Game six, folks. Back upstairs to Gary Thorne.
6:21 of the third overtime. Modano's 10th of the playoffs. Hull and Lettinen get the assists.
You could actually read the label on the puck as it came end over end. We kind of figured the way the goaltenders were playing, there would have to be something squibby like that or a weird bounce possibly, because the way Brodeur and Belfour played a standard type of shot, no matter how good it was, wasn't going to beat them.
41st shot, the Stars score. 48 for the Devils. Belfour stopped them all. So we go to a game six. Our final score, the Stars won, the Devils nothing. Al, all yours.
Well, so the crowd, a very disappointed crowd, obviously filing out of Continental Airlines Arena in East Rutherford, New Jersey. The Stars can take it to a seventh game with a win on Saturday night, a game you'll see on ABC at 8 o'clock Eastern time. And at least this crowd goes home knowing they might have one more chance to watch that cup skated around, but it will come Monday if it comes at all at this particular point. It's Mike Modano. 106 minutes, 21 seconds into the game at well past 1 o'clock in the morning sends the Dallas Stars home and still alive, winning it in overtime, 1-0 in triple overtime. Don't forget, tune in for game 6 Saturday night, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific time. Stay tuned for your local news and Nightline over most of these ABC stations. And this has been a presentation of ABC Sports and Association for ESPN. For more on the Stanley Cup playoffs, log on to abcsports.com, a part of the GO Network. This is ABC Sports, continuing the tradition of excellence.